The D-pad contains crude language, cringe humor, and suggestive themes. Viewer discretion is advised.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
We're gonna have our TV party tonight. Alright! We're gonna have our TV party, alright!
Hey.
Hey.
Okay, hey, do I sound right?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, cool.
Alright, well, I'm gonna start off. I'll do my own little intro. Blah de blah. Welcome to the D-pad. I'm DZ Dog. We got Austin.
Well, everybody's not here yet.
All the other people. Wait. Oh. How many more? Oh, yeah. Well, Mark is in here.
Yeah.
Shit.
Hello, this is Markiplier.
No, absolutely.
Hold on. I will be right back. I gotta
call
my girlfriend.
Where is Mark?
Hey, Mark.
Wait, is Unusual Caterpillar in this call? It says he's in here. I'm looking at the Skype faces, and his Ritsu avatar is here, but I don't know if he's actually in the call.
Yeah.
It's strange. I watched this really cool video about, oh yeah, he's typing right now. Oh no. Are you gonna have to use that one from the Logitech one from the 2000s? Oh, that one's even more broken.
Oh shoot.
Oh, it's good, man. This might be a replug. I don't know what he means by that. I don't know enough about microphones.
I'm just talking with Mark. He's getting ready. He was playing a game.
Yeah, I was in a call with my friend cucked by the laws of aerodynamics, we were just made this giant conversation about Europe because he's Norwegian, and I was talking about how I wanted to move to Germany when I get out of high school and all that. It was this huge conversation about European politics and, like, what it's like to live in Europe. And I've concluded that, Europe, 1, America 0.
In what way?
It's better. I like it more.
Yeah, I guess so, you know. Just depends, I guess, where you go.
Yeah. Specifically, like, Germany, because it has more...
Hello?
Oh, I can hear you now.
Holy shit! Okay, I rebooted Skype. I hate Skype. It's bad. It's not good. Fuck. Me.
Yeah, Skype is terrible.
Yeah, Skype's bad. At least Discord will show that my mic is working. Like, I needed to fucking reboot Skype. I tried unplugging my mic. That didn't work. So I was like, fuck, what can I do? Because it's showing that it's working. I fucking hate this thing so much.
Yeah. Discord is better, but, like, since so many people use Skype, it's kind of a necessary evil just to talk to certain people.
Skype is a dying medium. I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know. I know a lot more people who use Skype than Discord.
Nah. That's just, like, your opinion, man.
Let's see, where is Mark D?
I have no idea. He's told me to give him a moment. I guess he's going to do something real quickly.
Wait, let me pull up a list of all the episodes instead of using the fucking listings.
They're not in order. I need to actually, like, put them in proper order.
Wait, they're not in
order. I'm too lazy.
list of Star Wars The Clone Wars episodes.
Oh,
hell
I think
yeah.
Like, never
no,
mind.
No, I downloaded the entire, I torrented the entire series, and so I'm trying to label them all so that I know which episodes are which, and which ones I can use for maybe videos, who knows.
Wait a minute, is the D-pad out of order, D?
Technically, yes. I mean, all the episodes are there, like, in their own listing, but they're just not, like, you know, numerically in order.
So
I need to fix that.
Part two of one episode and stuff like that.
Exactly. It's a problem that I'm probably not going to fix for a while.
I don't know. I think, like, having a certain episode that's, like, a special is fine. I mean, people could just count them themselves. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Are we in the recording right now, or is this like a real world?
Hey, is Jeff?
No.
Yeah.
Are you just talking?
Yeah, we're just talking.
Fucking.
Dave Filoni.
So
episode two. That was a good episode.
That fucking Ready Player One video from the Crows. I don't know if you've seen that yet, Outlaw, but I know Larva has because we were talking about it.
Wait, what do you mean the file is open in eTorrent?
No, there's this video.
What do you mean the file is available in you? What if fuck you, bitch? uTorrent, you fuck is broken.
This video, it's probably the worst video I've seen today. It's just some fucking butthurt nerd getting angry that they replaced Ultraman with the Iron Giant in the Ready Player One movie.
So, like, that Razbowski video.
I will kill you and feast on your corpse. Fuck you. We don't talk about that.
Yep. Did you ever take the narcissism test after you did your Razbowski video?
No, but I should.
Yeah, that's...
No.
Did Raz, like, convince you to his side, or did you just keep arguing your stance?
Kind of. A little bit. Not really.
Yeah, it's... I'm surprised Raz found your video.
Yeah.
That's amazing. It was on the Razbowski subreddit, but that has, like, 14 people who actually follow that.
Yeah.
How many subs does that guy have?
He has, like, half a million? Oh, yeah. Over half a million.
And
video? Yeah, it's crazy.
That's pretty cool, even though it was a drama thing.
Yeah. The Mandalore episodes.
Oh yeah. In other news, I found a 15-hour long documentary of on movies, like a genre.
I like those.
It's on Amazon. You can buy the DVDs. It's like, you can't find it anywhere else, and I really don't want to because I'm not watching a 15-hour long video on the internet. But here's the DVD link. I remember watching it a bit in that film class I took over the summer, and it was pretty good. The narration.
Wait, hold
is kind of...
on a moment.
The narration.
Season 3? Okay. Fucking. I need to confirm this for a moment.
The narration's very odd, but, it's very good.
Holy shit! The fucking character that George Lucas plays in Revenge of the Sith has a Clone Wars episode dedicated to him.
Which character?
Baron Papanoida, the blue man.
Alright, I don't care anymore.
I think I've seen that episode.
I haven't. I did not know about it. I have not seen all of Clone Wars, but I should.
You should. I need to see the final season of it. The one that was on Netflix. The one that was there online.
Yeah. I watched a couple episodes, but then I was like, fuck it.
I need to send Jeff's channel link to Trench in the chat. Let me see here. being Jeff Duncan episode.
What did I miss?
Oh, nothing. We're just talking. Okay. Now we just gotta wait for Inch.
Am I a YouTuber?
What does that even mean anymore?
I don't know. I mean, like, if Larva could be... I mean, I guess, yeah. If Unusual Caterpillar here could be considered a YouTuber, then I guess I'm a YouTuber.
That's a pretty low bar.
I'm just saying, if this fucking idiot can be considered a YouTuber, then I'm definitely a YouTuber. So on the recording of this, I sounded like way too away. Am I coming through like that?
You're okay.
All right. Like, I'm listening back. I remember my audio was shit. Maybe my positioning's better. Maybe if I yell over here and like have it reflect.
Season 5 episodes.
Oh, yeah, the fucking new Magic School Bus trailer.
Never saw
also
it.
Also happened.
Yeah, it looks awful. It's like a freaking early 2000s Flash cartoon.
Looks like it was made using fucking those.
That's why it's great.
Looks like the Skechers character models commercial. Were made using that one Bitmoji app that like Snapchat's trying to push. And it looks terrible.
Right.
I haven't seen the trailer, but when I heard early 2000s Flash cartoon, I just got excited.
Like a public access Flash cartoon, like something on PBS.
Outlaw, your obsession with shit is kind of weird.
Yeah.
I don't know how to explain that, but I can understand.
It's just sort of an aesthetic interest.
I understand that. It's just like your sensibilities in low quality, the aesthetic desire of it are very, very weird.
Also entirely weird.
I mean,
like early PS1 games. I understand that.
Wholeheartedly. Is being Jeff Duncan 1 proof that I'm a YouTuber somehow?
Yes.
The worst video ever.
Yes.
Oh, you know what I did? A couple good episodes of season 6 is the first 4 and the Yoda arc, as well as the episode with fucking Sifo Dyas, because he shows up in an episode. It was pretty good.
How many gigs is this entire torrent of the Clone Wars taking up on your hard drive?
I don't know. I have like 2 terabytes, 3 terabytes altogether. So,
damn.
But how much space is this show wasting on your computer?
I wouldn't know. I'd need to check. Specifically,
I want you to know Joe season 2 because I have like 100 episodes of that sitting on the computer.
Yeah, I don't like download torrents to watch a show. That being said, yeah. I do have Evangelion and Gurren Lagann torrented because I wanted to watch those in HD, like good HD, like Blu-ray rip quality. So I downloaded.
Evangelion is in HD.
Yeah, no, the Blu-ray's been out for a while.
26 gigabytes.
That's actually not bad. But like, what quality are all the episodes in?
Hold on, let me find the torrent quickly.
They're like 480. They're 480. Then, good luck. I guess. Also, what file type are they using as well? That could also help.
MP4.
MP4. I guess it's just compressed more.
Because
my
this one 720p.
Well, I have a torrent. The whole
they're from the Blu-rays, so
yeah.
You're also
my Ava torrent takes up 23 gigabytes. And how many episodes is Clone Wars?
Hold on, let me go back to the official page. 121.
I don't know. I guess Evangelion is just that much better. It takes up the same amount of space. It also, I mean, actually, the entirety of EndeavA is only 5 gigabytes, but either yours are, like, compressed somehow. Better. They're probably just compressed better.
Yeah. Like, here's the torrent if you want to download all of Star Wars The Clone Wars.
You think I want to download all of Star Wars The Clone Wars?
Yes.
I can just go to Kiss. I can just go to Kiss Cartoon, all right?
But it's not, they'll have the watermarks. This has no watermarks.
Who cares about water? I like what? Like the Cartoon Network watermark that shows up.
Yeah, it'll it's prominently there. Like it is very noticeable.
But in the bottom better. In the bottom right hand corner, so I'm getting the full Cartoon Network watching it Saturday fucking night when you're like in third grade watching your Star Wars show. Experience, come on, you gotta get the accurate experience to how the show was aired, all right?
Exactly.
That's why when you watch Evangelion, you gotta fucking go on a subway and get attacked by with sarin gas. Come on.
I think I should know what that's referencing, but I don't.
During the production of Evangelion, there was a sarin gas attack on a subway in Japan that caused.
Oh, yeah.
Canceled.
Yeah, I've heard about that, but I didn't know how that correlated to Evangelion.
It was really similar to an episode they had planned, and they had to scrap the whole thing, which kind of led to the quote unquote budget cuts from the end of the series, but because of the Evangelion budget, it's fine.
Well, that was the thing.
Speaking of which, there's a guy in my school who doesn't like Evangelion. Well, I don't think he doesn't like it. Doesn't like it as much as he should. Anyway, I was gonna say he doesn't like Evangelion as much as he legally should. Because Anno said that, like, it was called Evangelion because it thought it sounded cool, and, like, the symbolism was there because it looked cool. Like, just the thing. Just, like, a thing Anno said in an interview one time, like, who cares? Because, like, the symbolism in Evangelion's not the big, like, important bit. Because it's not.
It's all about the aesthetics.
Well, not even. It's about the characterization. I know you hate Evangelion discussion, Outlaw, but sorry.
I don't.
That's fine. Yeah.
Weren't you? Did she, like, complain about that at some point?
I really love Evangelion, but, like, I don't know. I'm just tired of, like, Evangelion videos because I feel like it's talked about too much. But, like, just discussion with other people, it doesn't bother me because, like, what am I gonna complain that someone's talking about something? That's just silly.
Hey, man. Some people are like that.
I don't know. It just sounds sort of, it's a polite term to use for that. I guess it just sounds a little bit impatient to me. So, I mean, like, without, like, being, like, a total meme, like having it be the joke that I'm an elitist or whatever, like, I don't know, I try to be, even if I'm not interested in what people are talking about, I'm not gonna be rude about it.
Yeah.
But, I don't mind people talking about Ava. I like the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. It's nothing, honestly, to write home about, but...
Excuse me. It's the only thing to write home about.
Uh-oh. All right, I understand. I understand why people like it. I just... Maybe it was just so overhyped when I first watched it. I was like... Eh,
there we go. That's the correct thing to say.
It's the fan base. I think it's... What's keeping me from really enjoying it?
I know this feeling exactly. This happens to me all the time.
You gotta see fans from the fiction, man. Like, the fans are one group, and the thing itself is different.
I keep telling myself that, but I don't know.
Like,
I don't know. I don't hate it. I just, I thought it was all right. Maybe I need to watch it again. It's one of those things. It's like Office Space. You just gotta watch it a few times to understand it.
Yeah. Of course, the best thing about Evangelion objectively was the Karu Dojins that came from it.
Oh man, this guy probably jerked off to the 3.33 piano scene constantly.
I haven't seen 3.33 yet.
It's essentially just Shinji Kaoru fucking like yaoi-baiting the entire film.
Perfect. I gotta look up like that scene specifically. I don't even need to watch the movie.
Just look up Ava 3.0 piano scene.
Yeah.
Where they gaily play the piano together.
That's really cool.
Pretty fucking gay too.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah.
Not good. I don't know. I don't care. Whatever. If you want to look at that, that's fine. I just don't want to see it.
This is a Chandler podcast.
Western Chandler podcast.
All right. I'm fine. What goes on in a bedroom between two consenting adults is none of my business. However, if you're going to take that out of the context of two consenting adults in a bedroom, that's when I have to bring out the guns.
Like the Louis C.K. joke about gay people just having sex in public. Like, if he was basically saying that if religious groups were mad about that, like if they're just out just banging on your front lawn... then, yeah, he would understand the hatred.
Yeah.
But, I don't know.
Well, I think, like the holding hands and all that, or, just kissing in public, I think that's fine. Or it should be fine. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Have you ever gone to an American public high school?
Oh, yeah. I know exactly what you're talking about. It's pretty frowned upon, so I would say don't do it.
Yeah. Like, well, at least not inside of American public high school, because that's just gross. Yeah. I'm trying to learn, and these fucking children are fucking having sex in the hallways, all right? At least use a condom. Come on. All right? Don't get teen pregnant in high school.
That happened between actually three people in my grade in eighth grade.
What the hell's going on in your branch of the state, dude? Like, can you say where I live is trash? Like, at least I'm not having eighth grade pregnancies all the time.
I mean, it was way worse when my mom was a kid.
Was it? I think everything was worse when our parents were
kids. Yeah, that's true.
Aside from gas prices. Mm. No. Mm. Wait, no, the 70s happened.
Well,
never
back
mind.
In the 50s, the economy was real cool. And back when,
well,
back
were
when
your,
JFK was president.
Were your parents around in the 50s?
At
our age, our parents... At our age, our parents would have been around in the 70s, which was not the best economically.
The 70s was pretty bad from what I hear economically.
Shout out to stagflation.
And then when Reagan came in, it just got way worse.
What are you talking about? Reaganomics worked. Reaganomics works, man. It just works.
Oh, that's legitimately like one of the worst presidents of all time. I hate that guy.
Is he worse than number one worst president, Donald Trump?
Yeah, I'd probably say Reagan's not as bad as Trump. Trump is just goofy.
Yeah, Trump is
and
goofy.
Doesn't know what he's doing.
Like, Reagan did real damage. Trump is just a meme.
All right. right, can I get that in quoting when we go to nuclear war with North Korea? It's happening. Put it on your fucking tinfoil.
Oh, shoot. Gotta get that fallout shelter.
Honestly, considering what's going on right now, I would not put it past both leaders to just basically be like, eh, screw it, press the button.
Time to go to Germany.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh.
We all know what's going to happen. Let's just get it over with.
The thing that would... I wouldn't give a shit if America and North Korea went to nuclear war. But because I am... If North Korea were to get a fucking nuke across the fucking ocean, I would be in the fucking blast range. And I don't want that shit. Vancouver.
I live in Pennsylvania.
Are they gonna hit fucking Seattle? Like,
I don't know.
I mean, they might like try to just wipe out all of America.
Yep, that's why it's time to go to
Germany. Just spray and pray. That's right, loop the Turks.
I feel like wouldn't it be easier? I don't know. Isn't North Korea technically closer to Germany?
Don't talk about that. Don't crush my
There's
dreams.
A major hole in your plan.
Yep.
That's what happens when you live on a spherical Earth.
I guess it's time to go to Russia.
Again, right, literally right next to North Korea.
But they're allies.
You're right.
So I win in the end. Russia's not a hard language to learn. And it's a cool language, too.
That's how it goes.
But also, they have one of the most corrupt governments in the world. America meddled in their election to get Putin elected. We meddled in their election to get Putin elected. How much voting against our own interests is that?
That actually happened?
Yeah, I forget his name. I have to look through my freaking documents to find the guy's name. But basically, Marxist party had won in Russia. Like, they had won the vote. But, the American government was like, we do not want that. So, it ended up being that we chose Putin, for president. This guy was the guy who won. Gindy Yargarnov, I don't know how to say his name. He's like this Christian communist guy. But like, he had won democratically. It's just America meddled in the election, so he didn't get to be the president.
So what you're saying is Russia hacking our election is just them getting even?
Yeah, basically.
Hmm. I wouldn't be surprised.
And there was substantial evidence towards this. Like, it's not just a conspiracy theory. Like, I actually have a folder full of links to this stuff for arguments.
Oh, fuck. Oh, boy.
It's unbelievable. Like, I just have, like, a specific folder where I keep links to political stuff. I'm gonna be the next skeptic YouTuber.
Aren't you already
of
that?
Science.
Yeah, I'm the atheist of opinions.
My favorite.
Don't believe in opinions.
We're all skeptic YouTubers now.
The cynic of free thought. Oh boy.
Never was there a worse time to be on YouTube or the internet.
Because Outlaw Harvest has came here, and it's gonna trash everything up.
Is Pyrocynical a skeptic YouTuber?
No. He just kinda jumped on the bandwagon for views.
Like,
he just makes, like, commentary videos.
I don't know what he is. Like, I don't know what he does.
He does, like, those roasting videos, but I guess he decided that if he did a few of those, like, feminist cringe, like, roasting video things, that he would get more views. Like, I don't know if he actually believes, like, the I guess the core beliefs that the skeptics have or whatever. He's just kind of jumping on for that cash money. Which I don't blame him. You know, it's a smart thing to do. If I had that much patience, or if I even gave a crap, I would do that.
I could see that.
I'm just like fundamentally unable to like lie for money. Like, I just can't do it. It's just so far against my moral code that it would make me feel terrible.
You have a moral code?
Yes, Mark, I'm not a terrible person. It's just jokes.
Just jokes.
Yeah.
Quote unquote.
Like, I'm not actually a monster. It's just like, it's just me being ironic whenever I say something like terrible.
No one would actually have that opinion.
The freaking Digibro video.
If they did, then something is wrong with them.
Basically, Digi did this video where he talked bad about Fate and talked bad about Fate fans, and then at the end of it, he said that the joke was that no one would have that opinion, and it's basically a huge meme that he basically made himself look dumb by doing that.
I can see that.
Yeah, our old Digi bro. Gotta love him.
He certainly is an interesting figure.
Yeah, I'll give him that.
I need to start like an anti Digi channel and have you be the guest star, D, and just have us make podcasts talking bad about him.
Get what the what
would be, that would be great for that. And since I have connections with Mr. Cynical, I could totally do it.
You have connections?
Yeah, with Mr. Cynical, the YouTuber who made the Philosophy of Kreia, the 2-hour long video about Star Wars.
Oh, that's who he was. I seen that video.
Yeah, it's a great video. But he's in the Chromasticators chat, and he knows what the what.
Honestly,
made the anti-Digi video. But what are you gonna say, Mark? Go on.
I was gonna say about that video itself. Like, I liked it. I mean, the whole philosophy of Kreia and, like, what she believes in, how she believes the Force is this malevolent entity, and how light and dark are, it's essentially the same thing, just different principles and how the Force is used. To me, the Force is basically, to me, it doesn't matter how you use the Force. Like, the Force is neither good nor bad. It's mostly the people who use them. Which is really giving me, making me think about the new movie, how I think Luke may have come to terms with this and realized that literally perhaps it's time for the Jedi and the Sith to end and have people who are Force sensitive be like, you do you.
Yeah.
That'd be fairly interesting. It'd be interesting to see if he pulled it off.
But in the extended universe, Luke knows how to use Force Lightning, even though that's like a Sith ability.
So in KOTOR, you can use Force Light. You can use Force Lightning or Force Life Drain.
So I guess kind of just shows that it's neither good nor evil. It's just how you implement it.
Yeah.
This is why extended Star Wars lore is gay.
Yeah, kind of. The only good thing we got out of it was KOTOR 1 and 2, and maybe Republic Commando. I guess.
Republic Commando is good.
I hope they make a sequel to that one.
They won't. They won't. LucasArts. LucasArts is the only ones who made it. Yeah, it's gone.
One thing I might as well say this. Ewok Jedi.
That's my favorite thing.
Ewok Jedi!
Oh, have you seen their Red Letter Media's that nerd podcast they do? The newest episode?
It's a good podcast. About,
that's a good podcast right there. Very cool.
Very clean.
And they're talking about The Last Jedi and that new weird little furry creature. I can't remember the name.
The Porgs?
Yeah, Porgs. It's like, what is this? Yeah. Someone Photoshop a Furby into this scene? Looks very cool.
Rich, I think somebody Photoshopped a Furby into this movie.
With Red Letter Media, I can't imagine dedicating myself that much to Star Wars. I don't know, like, Star Wars is boring to me in the first place, but, like, I mean, they like it, sure.
This man gets it. This man gets it. Star Wars is boring. Gundam is better than Star Wars.
Wrong opinion.
No, Warhammer is better than Star Wars.
I agree with that,
too. Also, somewhat wrong opinion, but I do like Warhammer, so I can see the appeal of it.
I like Warhammer because of Magos.
Oh, fucking God damn it, of course.
Why did you not expect him to say that?
I don't know.
I'm honestly not surprised.
I'm literally...
Anyways, Gundam is better than Star Wars, and here's why, alright? No gay extended universe. Cool robots. You still get lightsabers, but you get cool robots.
Yeah. Depends
on alternate
continuity.
Alternate universe doesn't
count
because it's not good.
Yeah, and it's
G Gundam. No, you don't say
not,
that.
And it's also...
G Gundam was good. Okay,
and it's also not canon, so it's not, so it's ignorable.
It had a Gundam with a sombrero. Man, so your
is
argument
like,
is
like extended universe, like alternate, like extended universe Star Wars is like all canonical, right?
No,
not anymore. After Disney.
It used to be, but it used to be all canonical. So if you wanted the full story, you had to like watch all this gay bullshit.
You didn't have to
read books. If you wanted the full story, you did.
Just to fill in just...
Gundam, all you had to do is fucking watch UC and you're good. And the other shit is just other, like, side shit.
Fair enough. That's
kind of how the extended universe for Star Wars...
But it's books! It's not... It's out of the different media. Because most, like, Gundam books get adapted into the anime at some point.
Hmm.
Because Unicorn was a novel before it became an anime.
Oh, well, that's fine if you don't want to, you know, look through all that.
What I'm saying is I'd rather watch an anime about giant robots than a movie about fucking sand people throwing shit at each other.
Watch your language. Dune was good.
We're not talking about Zero Dark Thirty, man.
He said sand people throwing things at each other.
Oh.
That's exactly what I was talking about. Thank goodness Outlaw Harvest is here to get the joke that I definitely meant to say. That was definitely what I was meaning.
Zero Dark Thirty said about a black man with no money who lives with his mom.
No, this is not DZ Dog.
Zero's got no money, Dark. Exactly. Yeah.
He's gotta make an autobiography of DZ Dog. It's literally that concept.
And just kill myself after I'm done. Just last page is just this weird red splatter.
Yeah.
On every page.
Suicide.
Just spilled some spaghetti sauce. Okay.
It brings on me.
So, next topic.
And I can take or leave it if I please.
What do you think of fan games?
They're good unless they're a Pokemon game using its own original Pokemon, in which case you need to get out.
But Pokemon Uranium was decent.
The Pokemon looks shit. I don't want to play a game with shitty Pokemon.
I don't think Uranium was good.
I don't want to play...
Granted, I never played it, but...
I don't want to play a Pokemon game with Shin Pokemon. Alright? If I wanted to do that, I'd fucking play Gen 4.
I know nothing about Pokemon, but I do love Pokemon.
You know nothing about Pokemon, but you love...
That's the right mindset to have. No, it makes total sense.
I played the first game, Pokemon Blue, and that was really fun, and I watched most of the show, but I still don't, like, know anything about the games, not fundamentally. Like, I know the core fundamentals, and I know they're fun and cool, but I don't know about the series in terms of I've played lots and lots of them, and I'm, like, an obsessed fan. I just think it's really cool.
I've played probably not necessarily to completion, but I've played like every generation of Pokemon.
Oh, wow, that's really cool.
I wasn't around. I mean, if you count emulators, if you don't count emulators, I've only played up from Gen 3 on. But yeah, because I bought the virtual console Pokemon Yellow, because I was going to play through that and transfer all that into Pokemon Sun and Moon. But Gen 1 is kind of shit, and I hate it. And I've played through a bit of Crystal, haven't gotten that far, but I've played it enough to know how the gameplay is to Pokemon. I've played through Ruby up to Groudon and then transferred that into my game. I did that twice. And then I played Diamond through Sun and Moon to completion a lot of times, multiple times over.
Yeah. I played part of Diamond and I thought it was fun, but I think I got stuck at one part and then I didn't play anymore. What I want to play is the Game Boy Color ones. I forget which generation that is. Second one, Crystal.
That's Gen 2.
Yeah, Gold,
Crystal. Play Crystal. Yeah. Crystal definitely from like in every perspective is the best one of Gen 2. I really like how it looks in HD on my computer. Like upscaled Game Boy Color games look really fucking good.
Yeah, I played part of Vietnamese Crystal after watching Larva's Let's Play, and that was fun.
Why? Why would you torture yourself like this?
Because I am a Cro-Mag.
Not as good as
Grand. I didn't even know if there was a Vietnamese Crystal.
Yeah, it's a shitty translation of Crystal, but in Vietnamese. Like,
Mamma Mia, bootleg.
I haven't really touched the new Pokemon, but what I was referring to before I got distracted was the fact that there's a Spyro fan game in the works.
Sounds like it could be good.
It was originally called Spyro 4, but they changed it to Spyro Mystic's Tale, I think. I forgot the name of it, but from the way I understand it, they're trying to emulate the PS4. PS1.
I was about to say, trying to emulate PS4 probably isn't the best idea. But yeah, PS1, go for it, I'd say.
It's cool. Wait, Jeff, I thought you hated platformers.
Yeah, I do hate platformers, but like attempting to emulate like the style and like from a visual perspective, it'll probably look great if they're trying to emulate.
Yeah, it looks good. I've seen some images of it.
It's like how Sonic Mania, like, visually looks great, and I actually kind of want to play it because I can handle Sonic games. I just don't generally like platformers.
I think you made a good point about this in the Crows, but explain for those who haven't heard why you don't like platformers.
What, they're gay? That was
well,
my point.
Well, more than that, dude.
I forgot my point. I just don't like them. They're not fun to me. I'm bad at them, and I don't like them.
You said in the Crows that you didn't grow up with them or whatever, so you don't like them.
Oh yeah, that too.
A point I hear you make a lot. Like you specifically, I think you make this point more than anyone else I know. Is that I say I like SpongeBob, and then you say, "Well, the only reason people like SpongeBob is because they grew up with it." And then you say, when you say you don't like platformers, you say, well, I don't like them because I didn't grow up with it. It's just like a one-for-all excuse instead of, like, explaining what it what's wrong with it or what's good about it academically.
I mean, but like, I don't know. For stuff like that, I feel like it's kind of valid.
It's valid. It's just like less interesting. But what is interesting is that you say it so much, so it works.
That's right. That's right. I'm a nostalgia cynic.
Yeah.
I don't like it because I didn't grow up with
I
it.
Don't have to.
I don't like it because I don't have to.
You don't have to. Yeah, I can't do fucking Doug's voice. Voice is too monotonal. Dead.
Hello, I'm a nostalgia cynic. I don't like it because I don't have to. And today we're going to be reviewing SpongeBob Season 7.
Oh, boy. Now we can actually start, even though I was already recording. Hello, my name is...
Oh, wait, we're not... This is going to be like a 30-minute like introduction to the actual podcast. Addendum.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm the dog of the D's, but not really, and this is my show. Who are you people?
The show sucks, but that's why we love it.
That's right.
It sucks it. More than YMS at a horse show.
Yes, it sucks more than Ralph the Filmmaker on a daily basis.
We don't hate him because of his opinions, we just think his stuff sucks.
I hate him because he's gay.
I hate him because he has an opinion that I don't agree with and I'm childish about it. But that's besides the point. Welcome to the D-pad. No, we are not a porn podcast. Please stop saying that we are. Voices in my head.
I can make that.
Exactly. I'm DZ Dog and...
I'm Dragon King Mark.
There's other people. Dunkin' Donuts.
Jeffrey Dunkin' Donuts. Damn it!
Got it.
Don't fucking call me that. I'm Jeff.
Why do you have a video of Steven Spielberg hating Tokusatsu?
Because it's the worst video I've seen today.
Guys,
that video is shit.
He hates
but,
Tokusatsu.
But he's right.
Like, just because he's like that video isn't even about that. Like that's just a clickbait title. Like. It's really about some butthurt nerd, like, mad that his fucking references are being like, not included in the Ready Player One, the movie. Like, they're replacing Ultraman with the Iron Giant, and it's like...
The Iron Giant is for feels, not action.
Iron Giant is great.
Like...
Iron
hey,
Giant
don't
was
screw
amazing.
With me! I have the and power one of, the guy... of God and Tokusatsu on my side!
And one of the guys' points about like the book being better is that the author drives a DeLorean. Is like this guy has mad nerd cred. He drives a DeLorean. I think we're in good hands. This guy knows what he's talking about. He's a nerd like me. Yeah, he drives a car that's from a movie.
Someone said that Comic-Con Steven Spielberg wants everybody in the theater to point at the screen and go, "I remember that."
Yeah, I mean, possibly.
It was like, God, I mean, are we that much sheeple?
That movie just looks bad. In The Crows, I likened it to a joke from The Big Bang Theory. Let me see if I can find it again.
What if it has Big Bang Theory cast members in it? And it's like, I'm going to bazinga.
I wouldn't be too surprised if it did something.
That'd be great. It reminds me of this like joke from The Big Bang Theory. Like the opening... Like, 10 seconds have the joke in it. And
yeah,
like,
where they mention, haha, transfers, Thundercats.
Yeah.
Fuck you, how is this comedy?
Yeah, like the movie kind of
seems
like...
I'll tell you how it's comedy. It's where normal people can point at the screen and go, haha, they like kids, like, ha.
Like, and like the movie kind of just seems like that, the sort of like non-stop like referencing just for like effect of, oh man, I know what that is. Oh man, is that my favorite character from obscure reference? Oh man! Oh dude, is that Darth Vader my favorite political icon?
This is a Warner movie, so he won't be in there.
Oh man, is that fucking?
Is that Deadshot?
Is that Batman my favorite political icon?
Is that Light Turner my favorite anime hero?
Like that's what it's gonna be. It's gonna be shit. The book seems shit. Nerd culture.
Fan fiction.
Yeah, nerd culture in general is shit. It's the worst, like, internet subculture. If you buy pop vinyls, you need to kill yourself.
I've only have, I think, two. One of them's Ryuk.
That's too many. So
I only have one, and that was because I needed to buy it in order to fucking do a thing.
The other one is what thing?
It was a promotional thing where if you buy like $50 or more at Old Navy, then you get like $10 off. And my mom was like, "Oh, just buy a thing. Just buy it. Fuck it. I don't even care. I don't fucking give a shit about
you. Still gave Funko your money.
Oh, you're money."
you still gave Funko money.
Exactly.
So you're part of the problem. Burn it. Burn your Han Solo Funko Pop.
But
burn
it has a bobblehead, Jack.
Burn it. Snap video. Burn it and put it on
bobblehead.
Well, burn it and make you big. All right. Just remember that. Burning PC will kill you. But you generally should burn it.
And I just have two. One of Rhea Raven.
All right, burn those.
One, because they're incriminating evidence.
Yeah, you give Funko money, so now you gotta, like, I don't know.
To be fair, I'm more of a diamonds guy because NECA is trash.
Oh, no, NECA's shit.
They have great designs, but the plastic sucks.
Yeah, no, I got the one NECA figure I had broke on me within 5 minutes.
What was it?
It was one of the Pacific Rim ones.
Was it Gypsy Danger?
No, it was the Japanese one that didn't even show up in the movie. It just looked really cool.
Oh, Typhoon.
That's the Chinese. What? Something like that. It had like a jackal design. I don't know. I'm not sure if I'll find it. Something Ronin, I think. Anyway, when Band of Tamashii Nations announced that they had. That they got the rights to Pacific Rim 2, it was like a wave of relief.
Because I don't know, it's Universal. They tried to start a cinematic universe with The Mummy, so...
The Band of Tamashii Nations got the toy rights to Pacific Rim. Anyway, here's the figure I had.
Saw that at Comic-Con. I saw the Comic-Con photos. The figures look absolutely friggin' amazing, but I'm really more curious for Dino Select because they have the rights too. So I wonder, are they going to be just re-releasing all the Pacific Rim stuff?
They could potentially be doing that. Yeah, what really got me excited is the Solo Chogokin Misty Danger, because it's a Solo Chogokin figure. Which Solo Chogokin, for those uninformed, is basically the best super robot action figure line you can get.
Aren't they really small?
Soul Chogokins aren't. Super Robot Chogokin, the Step Down, are smaller, but they're also good because they still have diecast in them. But Soul Chogokin is supposed to be the best like figure version of a lot of these characters. That money can buy. Like, I have the Evangelion Soul Chogokin, and it's great.
You mean the less good Pacific Rim?
Oh, what do you mean? Shit.
Go.
I said it. Square up, Jabal. Let's go.
What? Gypsy Danger?
No, like, Pacific Rim is better than Evangelion. Because anime is trash.
Wait, are you the guy that said that? Are you the guy that had that, like, 6-point thing? Is that someone else? Outlaw.
I think that's Jobby the Hawk.
Trench posted on Facebook.
Yeah. Swivel right here. Swivel.
6-point thing about why Evangelion, or why Pacific Rim was better than Evangelion, and I. Yeah,
that was
yeah,
him.
That was him
this is the man.
Yes.
This is the man.
Oh my God.
Come on, square him.
No. What the fuck? Why the fuck are you shitting on Jobby for, man?
I like Jobby, but he makes it so easy to shit on him.
I know, it's great. That's why I watch him.
It's like, you fat piece of shit. Just like... But I love him, though. I want Jobby to be my little brother so I can inappropriately carry him in public.
Yeah.
Like Yoda.
He's a pretty cool dude. I'm glad that he's successful now. I've been following him for a while. No, I've just been following him for a while.
We should try to get him on this.
He might be. He might.
Maybe he'll be, like, spurting something all over a swivel when we're talking to him.
Yeah, I could talk. I could probably talk toys to him.
Like, maybe we could talk his Shinji impression.
Oh, yeah, it's terrible.
Because I, this is just like a thing that has carried over since me being a child. I just like constantly watch toy reviews online because I have nothing better to do.
Oh yeah, toy reviews are awesome. They're where you get some of the best ideas of whether or not you want a product. Because
before I got the
Ninja Turtles and Power Rangers movie toy line, I had to go through some critics first because I wanted to make sure, is this a real investment I want to have on my collection shelf? Luckily, they were mostly good except for the Shredder toy, which I had to buy two Shredders so I could merge the heads.
Hmm.
Thank goodness they were used.
Why? Yeah. Why are SH Monster Arts so expensive? I want the Shin Godzilla.
Shin
Godzilla!
Sucks! But the story around it was pretty good.
Yeah, it was a bit of an allegory to Japan and nuclear weapons.
No, it was an allegory for them during that tsunami attack.
Yeah, tsunami attack?
Yes, it was actually Godzilla farting in the water.
A tactical tsunami?
It was a tactical tsunami. That sounds like something from one of those Metal Gear games. We need you to launch a tactical tsunami.
That sounds metal as fuck.
We're gonna coin that right here. Every time we get angry at someone, I want you all to type down a tactical tsunami. Yeah, that's the D-pad. That's the D-pad podcast slogan. We're a tactical tsunami. Of nothingness.
At least we're not a Sharknado.
Fuck.
Where they just make sequels because they can't make anything else. Like, seriously, you guys haven't made a superhero movie yet?
I know Seth MacFarlane's making Seth MacFarlane's making a new show. It's called The Orville.
Yeah, where it's basically Star Trek The Next Generation.
Oh yeah, I saw that. I saw that and I just thought it was a Star Trek series because I hadn't seen it I haven't seen the trailer with the audio. But I was in the gym and they have TVs and the show was like, oh, it's the new Star Wars series, new Star Trek series, and it's not. It's some completely different thing, and it was the most confusing thing I've seen.
Man, but then again, Star Trek sucks.
Yeah.
Unless it's the Next Generation. Like, that's the one time I have to bow down to those nerds. Next Generation was really good because it has one of the best crying scenes ever, where Picard is in mud crying about how the Borg took him over.
Mm.
I was like, don't cry, Charles Xavier, don't cry. We've yet to see you die in Logan, which is even more heartbreaking.
Really? And not the sentient poop emoji?
No. Well, then again, I don't know which is worse, him dying and being buried in a godforsaken forest in Logan, or him a poop emoji yelling, we're number two.
His consciousness went to the phone.
No.
And became the
poop. I somehow remember owning a school for gifted young mutants. Trying to have creepy eyes towards Mystique, even though she's clearly younger than me.
Oh my god, the piano scene is so well animated.
Yeah. Oh, you're watching the fucking. The Ava 3.0 piano scene.
Yeah, this is amazing.
Well, I'm not going to diss the animation about Evangelion. They get top-notch people to work on it. But here's the thing. Does Shinji ever sit back and go, what the hell is all this? Why haven't we communicated with these things? Why hasn't no one gone up there?
Because I'm pretty sure that if...
You can't?
Hey, Angel,
no, I think they attempted. I think they attempted to, but the angels had them. I'm pretty sure if the angels at least told them that what they were really after and what...
I don't think the angels are a conscious thought. Aside from, like, Kaoru is, like, a weird exception. Because I don't think Kaoru is full angel. I think he's, like, I don't know.
But he's a statistical anomaly.
Yeah, I think the whole deal with Kaoru is that he is an angel, but I think he is, but I think
he's an angel.
He has the opposite of Rey, so that'd be, Here's soul.
The thing. Why can't all the angels take on a human form? Why is it just Kaoru?
I think Kaoru just has, like, Adam's soul in him.
I thought Rey was Eve.
Rumbleth. Eve doesn't exist. Eve are the angels, technically, if you go by the weird naming.
Oh, great. We have an orgy thing going.
Because, see? because something about the Bible and Lilith and shit. I don't know. I vaguely know what this is.
Yeah, we just pulled random shit from the Bible. We just stuck it to the air.
Well, I mean, because the Evas are Adam clones called Eva, and you can mess with that and you get even like in the Bible.
Bible.
And Lilith was like the one before Eve, and
you mean the book you see in a motel that you ignore?
Yeah. The free kindling, that they give me. I don't know why, but you know, it's a nice gesture.
The only people that kind of question anything are the people that have nothing to do with nerds. Kids at the school, you could tell they keep wondering, like, why the hell haven't we left Earth?
Honestly, yeah, that's the thing. What I was wondering about the third movie, like, they have a show. Why don't they just
our angel?
Well, because the third movie is shit. You don't watch the rebuilds at all. The only reason why you watch the rebuild is if you're trying to, like, show them to the girl you like at school who also watched Evangelion, and you're going to fucking bang to the rebuilds, all right? That's what's going to happen. That's the only reason why you watch the rebuilds.
Beats Dead Man Wonderland.
Yeah, I'm sad it never got into, like, a second season.
No, I'm glad it didn't. I actually did jig when I found out it canceled.
I never watched it. It just seemed boring and bad.
It was. It's so stupid. It's basically like a dumber version of The Running Man.
Like, the concept seemed alright, but, like, death games are done to death.
That wouldn't make sense in a prison thing, unless it was a post-apocalyptic future.
Yeah.
Where, if you
which is why we need Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, the anime, where it's just Thunderdome.
Or an anime of
Anime of The Running Man.
Oh, that'd be good.
The Running Man is a great movie, and you could tell it was inspired. But that Demon Wonderland stole that.
It's called Battle.
They made it dumber.
It could potentially be Battle Royale as well. I don't know. I don't know how close they are.
Battle Royale was also influenced by that movie. Although a schlocky piece of comedic 80s romp, has influenced a lot, and it's actually the better one of it because it was off the wall, insane, and a parody of American culture. By the time game shows were huge, just like in the 70s.
Yeah.
People would get into conflicts over who can break the most boom boxes to win $200.
Yeah. I need to fucking finish the goddamn book. I need to finish the book Battle Royale because like I got like halfway through and just never finished it.
Like a lot of things Japanese.
Yeah. But the book was pretty. The book was really good from what I read, so I need to finish it to read it all.
Do you guys remember the topics I posted?
Oh yeah.
Just
anime be adapted, I guess.
In the U.S. or as films or
yeah.
What? Oh, it's like a Ghost in the Shell, Death Note situation about.
Yeah, because believe it or not, sadly, those are the current. Better ones.
False on both fronts.
No, I mean like it's not horrendous beyond imagination.
Oh yeah, no. Those are definitely the best examples of a live action Western adaptation of anime. Because like the other one we got, the other two are Speed Racer. I need to watch it again, but I've heard
Racer actually is pretty dang good. At least to me,
like I've heard is good.
Fuck
like Aaron,
you.
I know Aaron Hansen Fuck loves you. It, so I just need to rewatch it. But Dragon Ball Evolution is just irredeemable.
Yeah. Dragon Evolution
Speed
never
Racer will never be redeemed because they never say I need to go fast before I come. You don't have that. You are not Speed Racer.
It just says some verbal tick.
They do the dubbing thing. They have the camera things where they're always below angle shots.
I can't do the scene. But the scene where like you like, I forget. I need to find it. 1 second.
Or the announcer going now right behind Speed Racer X, the mysterious rival. It's like, oh come on, where is that? That's what people loved about it. It was kind of like a dumber version of Scooby Doo. God help us when they adapt Voltron into a movie, which is going to happen whether we like it or not. Hell, we already have to put up with the Tumblr cringe remake on Netflix.
No, that's wrong. That's good.
It's all right. It's kind of hard to get into.
Dirty Gaijins should never get their hands. That's the greatest thing I was talking about. Dirty Gaijins should never get their hands on a on superior Eastern culture. Fucking goddamn Baka Gaijins need to get out.
Yeah, get out. Get out style. Get the fuck out.
But like I say, I mean, like adaptation, like live action adaptations are not necessarily evil, just incredibly hard to pull off, and haven't been pulled off well ever.
Yeah,
I would say that Voltron pulled it off very well.
Live action, dumbass.
Oh, I meant just like in general. Like, because that's a TV show that works better. It was intended to be a live action movie.
I mean, Voltron probably could work as a tokusatsu, but,
Yeah, that would... People would turn it off in an instant. It's like, oh, great, it's another Power Rangers
like
one.
Like Steven, like, Steven Spielberg wouldn't even watch it, so...
Steven Spielberg hates tokusatsu.
Yeah, because we already know that Steven Spielberg hates tokusatsu, so...
He hates everything that doesn't have to do with his works or a book.
Yeah, well, you basically sold. Well, he sold. He shouldn't really be talking because he sold. Because he sold to Disney, so
he sold to everybody.
Disney sold out. Disney's not necessarily evil. There's just Disney,
especially Paramount.
Terrible.
Disney is very evil.
Guess what directors he took under his wing?
Did you not know what I said? I said that Disney isn't terrible, but they're Disney, so they're evil. Disney sucks, and I hate them as a company. None of them.
I just don't like
them
because they're creepy.
Like none of them are even good. Disneyland is a shill.
It is.
Don't go. I've never been. But I never want. I've never been.
Do not go. I've been.
I just think they're creepy.
Too late for that.
All I did this weekend was just watch videos about like shut down Disney theme parks, and it was great. Discovery Island is the only good thing Disney ever did.
I agree.
Also, people who go on cruise ships for like vacations need to jump off the ships into the propellers.
From Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because
I don't like Spielberg movies.
It's funny because Jurassic Park and Indiana Jones are two of my favorite movies.
Speaking of
Jurassic, I don't like them, but they're okay to watch on a plane or on a bus ride.
Jurassic Park is unironically a 10 out of 10 amazing film, so shut up.
I agree.
I was actually have you guys actually heard that they're making another Jurassic Park game? But this one's actually a sequel to like the Jurassic Park game where you can create your own park.
Oh man, are they making a sequel to that?
Yeah, they are. It's called Jurassic Park World Evolution.
Finally,
I'm like, yes.
That's gonna.
But when are they gonna make Lego? But when are they gonna make Lego Jurassic World 2?
Oh, whenever the next one comes out.
Sorry.
It's like next year.
It's the Jurassic World Extended Universe.
Yeah.
I wouldn't mind that.
Honestly, like
more dinosaurs.
One of my friends doesn't like Jurassic Park, and I don't know why. Like, his reasonings are like, the effects are bad, which is false. Have you not seen the movie recently? It looks
great.
The old
effects, I think, look better than... I'm going to get flack for this, but I think the old movie looks better than the new one.
Oh,
yeah,
no,
that,
the old
no that is a very popular CGI. Opinion.
Really?
Yeah, no.
Wow.
Like, because... yeah.
Say what you will. But an old film using practical effects has a longer impression than a film using CGI because they feel real.
Yep.
I like the second Ninja Turtles movie, but the first movies were always good because they had realism to them, because they were physical things that were touching things. Like, you know it's a guy in a suit, but when he picks up a piece of pizza from Domino's or drinks a Coca-Cola, he's actually doing it.
Yeah, that's a very common like ideology people have about movies.
Or gore. Like you see a dummy or a fake head's like head explode like in the original 80s Maniac movie. It feels real because that's something actually being blown up with a real shotgun in the middle of the night in New York City in the 80s.
Yeah. But anyway, that's can we talk mean. About how Blade Runner is the best film ever made?
It is.
And how the new one is going to kill it, and it's going to be shit. Ryan Gosling,
I don't think it's going to be shit. I think it's going to be good. But here's the problem. I think it's going to be like the original and bomb horribly because
opening
up next to another Minions movie, right? Like,
yeah, like Did you not have you seen the like? He's apparently releasing a bunch of short films leading up to the release of one. I don't know where the other one.
I like the one where it involved Jared Leto, where he's blind and asks a replicant to stab himself.
Oh yeah, yeah, no, I asked. Yeah, that one. That's the one.
Even there, even the people's like, he's a replicant, but dude, that's fucked up.
Yeah, yeah, no, yeah, that's what I was talking about. I think that's the only one that's out right now.
My only problem is, wait, replicant robots?
No, they're not. No.
Oh, they're just clone people.
Yeah, they're like weird clone people. Yeah, Baddie was like bleeding in the movie.
Like, I wonder if he's going to give a speech to Ryan Gosling.
What, Harrison Ford?
Yeah. He's like, I forgot the speech. Get off my plane.
Fucking, I really hope that they don't go the Deckard as a replicant route. That only Ridley Scott likes. The concept, like, no one else think they should do it, but like Ridley Scott really likes the idea of Deckard being a replicant, and it's dumb.
But then again, the movie kind of hinted at it because no one gave Deckard respect. They treated him like he wasn't even human. Like, especially that guy who speaks city speak, he's just like constantly insulting him. He's like, hey, you did a real man's work.
Yeah,
what are you talking about? I just got my ass kicked and my fingers broken.
Yeah, but like, and then like everyone's talking about the unicorn, but that was added in later for the final cut.
So many cuts of that movie.
Just watch Final Cut. I have them
final
all.
Cut Pro, you mean?
Yeah, the only good editing software.
No, you're wrong. Premiere is better.
What about Avid or Pinnacle?
Avid's good.
The actual professional tier ones, unlike Premiere, you fag.
No. They used Premiere to edit Shin Godzilla and Deadpool and other movies. So
fuck. Isn't it weird that some of the shots in Shin Godzilla were made on an iPhone?
Were they really now?
Yeah, certain shots the interior of buildings where Godzilla's walking by, that's done with an iPhone.
Yeah.
Mm. Wow.
That's called a resource.
Like, filmmaking's evolving, which is kind of why how people who make movies with an iPhone nowadays are better than people in charge of making billion-dollar franchises.
Yeah, your camera phone is like actually like way more powerful than you think it is.
Than a Canon TF whatever.
Yeah, like it can't like if you know how to use like lighting and shit well, you can use your Canon camera phone really well.
But yeah, back to adaptations. I think adaptations are getting better. Like, say what you will about Ghost in the Shell and Death Note, but it didn't make you want to just burn the theater down after seeing it. You went going, okay, I see what they tried to do. This was a real fan of this.
But
a studio was stepping in.
Yeah. About Ghost in the Shell, I wouldn't have known because the audience when I watched it was terrible. Fucking, alright, it was a bunch of kids, alright, with their goddamn fidget spinners, taking Snapchats during the entire movie with the flash on, talking over each other during the movie. They didn't watch the movie. They walked into the theater, alright, and fucking did whatever they were doing outside the theater, in the theater, during the movie that they paid money to watch, but they didn't fucking watch it. Why are they in the goddamn theater?
And you
because
didn't
they knew
toss
you were there.
Popcorn at them. You should have tossed
they
popcorn
there,
at them.
So they brought their fidget spinners and Snapchats to just annoy you.
Like, and then, like, someone fucking called the, staff on them, and they just gave, like, a stern warning, and they went back to it. They didn't kick them out, alright? I would have, like, fucking, like, kicked them out of theater and banned them from, like, every establishment.
And then just get the DVD of it.
But then it's not, like, the same. Like, I wanted to watch it in the theater because I, like, I don't know, maybe I could, like, because the movie visually, Ghost in the Shell, looks pretty good.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to see that.
I'd make a case that it It was decent. It was a decent
movie. Yeah, okay, it wasn't bad. All right, the movie was not bad. It was just
boring.
It was just boring and left no impression.
I guess that was the original movie. It's hard
The original was very boring.
Yeah.
The original was
it
not boring
at all. It felt like
after
the movie was over, a professor was going to hit his cane on your desk and ask you to write notes about it. Like,
no, the original was not boring at all. Like, I really, really loved how slow-paced it was. It felt really good.
Yeah, it's much it's like Blade Runner, the most boring, amazing film of all time.
I don't know why people think Blade Runner is boring either.
I think you're confusing Blade Runner with 2001: A Space Odyssey.
No, that's the greatest film ever made besides Christmas Day.
Yeah, but it's also boring.
Boring as shit.
Anyway,
it is pretty boring.
Oh all shit. Right.
I've
read like the first couple of chapters of the 2001 novel, and it's boring
it's,
as fuck.
Like,
it feels
really good, like when they spend giant amounts of time like just out in space and there's no sound. It immerses you in the atmosphere, and it's not all fast paced where it gets all boring. Basically, it's just a subjective difference of taste there, where I like things to be very, very slow. And 2001 does that poignantly and competently, and so I like it. But, like, and I'm specifically an outlier of that because, I praise the scenes where it goes really, really slow. Specifically the ones where, it's just, like, a guy out in space. Like, I really like that. I kind of obsess over those parts, and like most people, they complain about those. So, I don't know. Like,
I mean, I understand it's a guy in space talking to a computer, but I like to imagine that they're Rick and Morty.
Yeah.
I need the.
Sorry, Dave. This conversation serves no purpose. Goodbye.
I need to watch 2001 again, probably like in the dark, because I was watching. I just need to get a different like setting for it, probably.
Yeah.
I'd probably really like it if I like watched it again.
I
just didn't understand.
I just
didn't understand the what was happening with like, because I was like, I just needed just
I first watched the movie when I was 8, and I thought I understood it pretty well. Like, there's some.
I don't know. I guess I wasn't paying that much attention.
I mean, there's some like political subtext in the movie, but I don't think that actually matters. It's only like postmodernists and hipsters who care about that stuff. Like, the main meat, like, of what the actual movie is, I think it's pretty easy to understand, but I don't know.
Yeah, I just need to watch it again.
Like, I don't know. When I saw that movie when I was 8 years old, that I was like blown away. It was like mind expanding at the time. I loved it so much. And not for any pretentious reason. It's just I really was just enthralled by it with just a childlike sense of wonder when I saw it. Like, basically my experience with 2001 is what a lot of people have with Star Wars.
Well, you see, I didn't grow up with 2001, so, like, I probably don't appreciate it like you do, so...
Same here.
I mean, I thought about watching it, but I can't get past the monkey scene, because I got so bored during that part.
The monkey scene's great.
Yeah,
I thought
that was amazing. Again, that was, like, another one of those scenes where it was like, whoa, it's like evolution, and they're doing a thing, and it's, whoa, dude, this is...
God, evolution was so boring. It took so long to get things done. Freaking lazy monkeys.
Yeah, I need to watch.
Evolve faster.
So I probably just need to watch it
again.
It's
just all these new cons.
No, but I really like the monkey. The monkey scene's great. I just need to watch the rest of the movie again, probably.
I need to get that.
I actually think for now that Death Note is one of the better anime adaptations because, one, that anime can get super long, and I've never seen the anime, but I've seen bits and clips of it, and it looks like it really has this slow burn thing. And this felt like, when I saw the movie, it felt like an homage to those old 80s films, where it felt like it was this collection of things put into one thing to where it was very cohesive for me. But I do have to admit, the guy that got to play Light was not the best thing. I mean, clearly the girlfriend was probably supposed to play Light, but at the last minute is like, change it to a dude and make her the girlfriend.
Yeah, but
Because if you traded out,
how do you guys feel about the gender swapped fucking Lord of the Flies that they're doing?
I don't know.
Is it still
going to
end where all the kids cry when they see adults there?
Oh my god!
Probably.
I just find that ending so funny for some reason.
Lord of the Flies is a great book.
It really is.
Because it shows the bitter reality of humanity.
Yeah. But they're probably going to like doll it up a bit, you know, because.
Are they going to make it? What would happen if Michael Bay got to direct it?
Dude, I would be all over that.
That'd be
right
the
away.
Funniest movie ever made.
Yeah, man. Yep. Like, you do, man. Michael Bay.
Are we still talking about 2001: A Space Odyssey?
Yes.
We're
talking about why Death Note, the movie, is better than 2001.
No, it's better than Ghost in the Shell.
We're talking about how the gender swapped Lord of the Flies is going to be the best film to hit modern cinema of all time.
Can we just all say the actor who plays Light in Death Note is really cute?
No,
he is. He's also part of the Naked Brothers Band.
Yeah,
is he?
Yes, he was the older brother character and had one of the best scenes in cinema history.
I'm not a gay boy, so I don't know.
But seriously, he's obviously a nice kid, and I just felt like it was a joke that they told him to act like that. And like, he's like, is the scene good? He's like, totally. Why is everyone snickering every time I'm on screen? No reason.
They should have got the guy from Fault in Our Stars and Baby Driver.
Wanted to get that guy from
get Ansel Elgort. Get Ansel Elgort, man, the best. I don't know. Baby Driver was good. I haven't seen him in anything else, but
yeah, I need
Taxi
to see
Driver
that.
Was really
but I
good.
I need to see Taxi Driver. I keep seeing good things.
Oh man,
about
I need to, I really need to watch.
Are we talking
Speed?
About my favorite game for the Sega Dreamcast, Crazy Taxi?
No, Crazy.
I really
Rebel
the,
Taxi is better.
I really need to watch Speed, the movie about the bus that explodes if it goes doesn't go slow. Or it goes too slow. So
that movie. Oh, that's what the movie was.
What?
Oh, I forgot to mention the day the trailer dropped.
Speed.
The next Netflix is The Magic School Bus.
Oh yeah, no, it looks terrible.
Before I turned it on, I said, "Please let this be a normal trailer." But the frizz?
With the
no
frizz?
Way.
No way.
I mean, the trailer itself seemed normal, but the show looked like a garbage fire.
Is it animated or?
It's animated, but it looks like. Honestly, I'm fine with it being like a 2D Flash. I just hate the character designs. They look like fucking Bitmoji.
Have
terrible.
You seen the Magic School Bus?
The Magic School Bus looks fine. All right, it looks better than what they're doing now.
Because what happened in the Magic School Bus? Robin McKay, were these kids on acid or something?
No, they were on a Magic School Bus.
I've always had an idea of Magic School Bus pair where they're about to drive off, and then a bus hits them. Ironically, another bus hits them, sending the Magic School Bus to explode, and that's just a montage while the music plays and the kids being hauled out of the bus. It's that they were all like covered in heroin needles.
Fucking Green Bird from Cowboy Bebop starts playing as they fall out of the fucking. No, from episode 5 where he falls out of the window.
Oh no, I was thinking more just the Magic School Bus theme where it's playing and like there's a jukebox like somehow out of there or like a record player that's playing the Magic School Bus theme.
So it's the juxtaposition of the terrible with the happy. Okay, all right.
Yes, I love that stuff because like what's more better? It makes people feel really uncomfortable.
Very postmodern of you.
I don't speak hipster, so
I don't.
Just wanted
I don't.
To make something
oh,
fucked
the
up and
anarcho-capitalist
funny.
Doesn't speak hipster. Okay.
So.
Says the anarcho-capitalist.
I'm afraid that this is our new YouTube fad.
Yeah, where we call each other fascists and capitalists.
Oh no!
That too. But
yeah, this might be our new.
Harvest is trending on YouTube.
What? It says get fucked, fatty. Not too harsh.
Whoa. Not harsh enough. I mean, you know, we don't want Kitty to manually demonetize us.
That's right. She did it.
You let her run your life.
As if we weren't demonetized already.
Yep.
Oh my god! This video is shit.
No.
Oh man, he's doing it. He's gonna axe a keyboard, guys. He's gonna take an axe to a keyboard.
The D-pad will be the next Allied Powers.
Why are you watching it?
I'm just trying to
Why
fucking
Why are you
see...
watching Adult Swim?
Yeah, okay, this seems like shit.
Speaking of Adult Swim, what would you guys say if they were to ever bring Megas XLR onto Adult Swim?
I wouldn't care, because I haven't seen the original.
I am currently watching the original. I got up to episode 4 a few hours ago.
And my opinion on old children's cartoons has already been set in stone as I don't like them. Not a big fan.
No. You would probably just imitate Trevor Belmont. I don't care.
Like,
that's literally what he says. Like, in the first few episodes.
Just Castlevania?
Yeah, the new Castlevania.
More like Slut Sylvania.
Super Mario Brothers movie was a better adaptation.
Whoa. This is a politically correct show here.
Yeah, use your nouns, you Sith male.
This is a very liberal podcast. There are no right wing beliefs.
Super Mario sibling.
Can we talk about the real hard news going on? Mario is no longer a plumber.
He's no longer a plumber. He is a sewer serviceman. Thank you, right. Service person. Sorry.
So Nintendo is like Mario's no, like he like they like for like Mario Odyssey. They were like. Mario like had like a whole like bio on Mario, and he's like used to be a plumber. So Mario is no longer a plumber.
He's
made so much money from all of his adventures. You'd think he'd still be plumbing?
I don't know.
So much money.
He's paid.
He just does it for the.
But he's diabetic, so he doesn't eat it.
He just does it for the love of the job, man. You know.
He's a scat fetish.
I just thought he's the guy who's in the permanent friend zone because. He realizes a princess doesn't want a bone, a fat, short, mustachioed, stereotypical Italian man.
This is a politically correct show. We do not use such
AKA
shows.
Movie Bob.
Oh.
What? A Movie Bob, my hero.
Movie Bobbio.
Your hero is a zero.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, dude, you fucking got him there, dude. He's like... Dude, man, he's gonna have to fucking take like a lot of fucking time to like recover from that sick burn, fag.
Okay, like you just gave up halfway through. Just use the horrible expletive because you're just bombing. Just might as well just go with style, you know. Just
go
gusto.
Out with style.
Go big or go home.
Yeah. Like. Yeah.
Yeah, like Shinji in that one doujin.
Where him and Kaoru fuck and Third Impact happens, because of that, and
Wait, have you read that one?
Instead of
David, like, yes,
wait,
I think we just
that,
no.
That's real.
Fuck this anime.
Just for the sake of the joke, YMS was there, but he was a horse with his long hair. Going, wow, I sure didn't like this.
You're telling me this is Ava Dojo, where Shinji and Kaoru fuck causing Third Impact.
This is real.
I was just joking.
It's a too much time in our hands.
Too much time. We're all nerds. We have way too much time in our hands, and we'll be that way even when we have careers and families.
Yep.
That's honestly great.
It shows the bitter reality of man. No matter what, we will always have too much time on our hands, even though we complain that we don't have enough.
Hmm.
No, you always do have time on your hands.
Outlaw. Does the fucking happen because of the... Like, does Third Impact happen because they fuck, or is it because they're too busy fucking
at
Third Impact?
I don't know. I can't...
They're calling him in his put-on voice dial.
Oh.
That's not translated. Hmm. Or is that a joke?
I hate it when, like... dojos are translated into other languages that aren't English, because it's like...
I fucking know, right? It's bullshit. Why does China get dojos before we do? That's fucking gay.
Why does China... I thought China banned porn.
They did! And that's what doesn't make any fucking sense. Is why does China get the fucking good dojos when we don't?
Because they own us.
Why can't I fucking like jerk off to fucking the fucking Gerudo Link from Breath of the Wild getting pegged by that one Gerudo chick while that in my fucking native tongue? Come on, man.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Exactly. That's something that lost it.
Yes.
Wasn't that good anyway, so whatever.
But yeah, second topic is about fan games. Do you think fan games should be allowed?
No. We must ban them. Like, we must ban the free market.
I mean, it's fine. They're fine, but like, I don't necessarily care for like Pokemon Uranium, like, because it just doesn't look good to me.
Ban them.
Fans in general need to stop.
Are
anyway,
we eugenics
they
fans?
Suck. Yeah.
Because that's definitely how it works.
All right, I'm gonna hijack this podcast now. We're gonna talk about how eugenics is justified, and how what Iceland is doing with Down syndrome is what we should be doing with all disorders.
What?
Yes.
So we just kill everyone on this podcast.
Yep.
Fair enough.
Yeah,
we're all too autistic to live.
Yeah, because like in Iceland, just parents who test their fetuses, and if they get like positive tests for Down syndrome, they're like, most of the time they'll abort the fucking fetus, and it's like the smart thing to do because you're either knowledgeably burdening your child with this incurable lifelong disease, or you're ending it before like it even has a chance to live, which is better than having Down syndrome.
That's kind of messed up.
Fuck you. Abortion should be legal. It's not your
my
choice.
My body, my choice.
I agree.
Exactly.
I agree.
Honestly, I don't see how this is an issue. Like, if you don't believe in it, then you don't have to do it. But, like, let other people do it if they feel it, they should be able to do it.
Yeah, it's the exact same logic I have with why I believe, like, all drugs should be legal.
Yeah, no, I believe that too. Like,
yeah.
Like, you know, like, safely get it to them, like, but, and if you don't, like, want to do it, then you don't have to do it. Right? It's also why, like, abstinence-only sex education is bad, because people are going to fuck. You might as well educate them on what's going to happen when you stick your dick in that vagina, alright? You're going to get AIDS or the girl pregnant.
Yeah, but I also believe that schools should not be required after a certain point, and that it should be more democratic.
Yeah.
Like, you should be able to choose what you get.
Like,
and you should be able to choose.
I feel like
that's
there
how
be...
it is in Canada. We're allowed
like
to choose what we take.
I feel like that there should be some sort of like standards that you have to take, but largely free. Like,
yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Like, graduate, you should have to take, like, a math, science, English, social studies class. Like, maybe, like...
Let me explain to you why the school system in Canada is way better than the one in the U.S. right now.
Because you guys are actually, you know, giving them attention, whereas we're just basically giving us subjects and just be, like, not really discussing with it.
Somewhat, it's still kind of stupid and gay, but for eighth grade, you have to take all of your mandatory classes, English, language studies or whatever, social science, math, and then whatever else, I think, elective courses or whatever, PE, that kind of thing. But then once you get to grade 10, half of those drop. Like, you drop most of those courses after grade 10. In grade 11, it's, like, math, language, science, and English, math, science, and what else? There's one more, I feel like. Anyways, and then French. my grade 12, English, math, science, and French or language study. And then once you get to grade 12, all you have to do is take English and your language. And then everything else is a choice. Like this year, because I fucked up chemistry big time last year. So I'm taking English, French, and biology. And then the rest of it is like elective classes. Get fucked. I'm telling you why it's better. It's a better system.
Are you shit talking the superior science biology? Like, chemistry is shit. Alright? I'm failing chemistry right now because they
fucked up chemistry big time. Jeff, I got a 19% in chemistry second term last year.
Oh my god. How are you gonna go to college with that such a shit GPA?
Crazy.
Why can't I go to the socialist Canada? Larva, can your family adopt me for the rest of my high school career?
Yeah.
The half the fucking semester that it is.
Totally.
All right.
I actually read somewhere that
I'll fucking exchange student into your school.
Yeah.
What were you gonna say, Mark?
I read somewhere that someone actually was going to. When they finished their school, like their school term and stuff, they were like, I kind of wish that they taught me these three skills. Woodsmanship or woodcrafting, home economics, and, well, economics. Yeah. Because quite literally, those are the only three skills that you need when you're done with high school.
Those are things that you can take. I took home ec first year in grade 8. Because it was like a mandatory thing. It's like you take three electives and you rotate through it. And it's home ec, economics, and woodworks.
The three mandatory
classes. I think other people got like foods first term, but whatever. Anyways, but those are like three electives that you rotate through each semester or each term. And it's the best thing because you get to sample everything. And if you don't know that something's not for you, and you don't take it next year.
Mm.
Yep.
No, just something I know is because if I'd known that, I would have taken those classes. Then maybe I could be at least, you know, proficient.
Yeah.
With like those classes.
Yeah. The thing about school is that it doesn't actually prepare you for real life or for critical thinking. It just prepares you to go in the job market. And even then, it doesn't do that. Like, the entire point of school is not actually to educate you. It's to put you into a job, you know, and then to be in a job forever, basically. So basically, it's a spook. They don't actually teach you things. But if it was done, you know, more democratically, and if there was more actual stuff to do, and there was reforms to how it was taught, like, even then, like I say, it's for getting a job. That's the point of school. But even then, it does that terribly.
Pokemon, in which case you need to get out.
But Pokemon Uranium was decent.
The Pokemon looks shit. I don't want to play a game with shitty Pokemon.
I don't know. I thought Pokemon Uranium was good.
No, whatever.
I don't want to play.
Granted, I never played
I don't want to play a Pokemon game with shitty looking Pokemon. All right. If I wanted to do that, I'd fucking play Gen 4.
I know nothing about Pokemon, but I do love Pokemon.
You know nothing about Pokemon, but you love.
That's the right mindset to have. Sense. No, it makes total sense.
Yeah, like, I played the first game, Pokemon Blue, and that was really fun, and I watched most of the show, but I still don't, like, know anything about the games, not fundamentally. Like, I know the core fundamentals, and I know they're fun, and cool, but I don't know about the series in terms of I've played lots and lots of them, and I'm like an obsessed fan. I just think it's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
I've played probably, not necessarily to completion, but I've played like every generation of Pokemon.
Same.
Oh wow, that's really cool.
Like, I mean, it wasn't around. I mean, yeah, like, yeah, because I have if you count emulators, if you don't count emulators, I've only played up from Gen 3 on.
Emulators count.
Yeah, because I bought the Virtual Console Pokemon Yellow, because I was going to play through that and transfer all that into Pokemon Sun and Moon, but Gen 1 is kind of shit, and I hate it. And I've played through a bit of Crystal. I haven't gotten that far, but I've played it enough to know how the gameplay is. It's Pokemon. I played through Ruby up to Groudon and then transferred that into my game. I did that twice. And then I played Diamond through Sun and Moon to completion. A lot of times, multiple times over.
Yeah. I played part of Diamond, and I thought it was fun, but I think I got stuck at one part, and then I didn't play anymore. What I want to play is the Game Boy Color ones. I forget which generation that is. The second one, Crystal, and...
Yeah,
Gen 2.
Gold, silver, Crystal. Play Crystal. Crystal, yeah. Definitely from, like, in every perspective, is the best one of Gen 2. I really like how it looks in HD on my computer. Like, upscaled Game Boy Color games look really fucking good.
Mm. Yeah, I played part of Vietnamese Crystal after watching Larva's Let's Play, and that was fun.
Why would you torture yourself like this?
It's not as good as Grand.
I didn't even know there was a Vietnamese Crystal.
It's a bootleg.
Yeah, it's a shitty translation of Crystal, but in Vietnamese.
Mamma Mia, bootleg.
And I haven't really touched the new Pokemon, but what I was referring to before I got distracted was the fact that I found out that there's a Spyro fan game in the works.
Sounds like it could be good.
It's called. Yeah. It was originally called Spyro 4, but they changed it to Spyro Mystic's Tale. I think I forgot the name of it, but. From the way I understand it, they're trying to emulate the PS4, like the PS4. PS1.
I was about to say, trying to emulate PS4 probably isn't the best idea. But yeah, PS1, go for it, I'd say.
Yeah, it's cool. Wait, Jeff, I thought you hated platformers.
Yeah, I do hate platformers, but like, attempting to emulate like the style and like from a visual perspective, it'll probably look great.
Yeah, it looks good. I've seen some images of it.
It's like how Sonic Mania like visually looks great, and I actually kind of want to play it because I can handle Sonic games. I just don't generally like platformers.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think you made a good point about this in the Crows, but explain for those who haven't heard why you don't like platformers.
What, they're gay?
Well, that was my point.
Any more than that, dude.
I forgot my point. I just don't like them. They're not fun to me. I'm bad at them, and I don't like them.
I think you said in The Crows that you didn't grow up with them or whatever, so you don't
That too.
But which is a point I hear you make a lot. Like, you specifically, I think you make this point more than anyone else I know, is that I say I like SpongeBob, and then you say, well, the only reason people like SpongeBob is because they grew up with it. And then you say, when you say you don't like platformers, you say, well, I don't like them because I didn't grow up with it. It's just like a one-for-all excuse instead of, like, explaining what's wrong with it or what's good about it academically.
I mean, but, like, I don't know. For stuff like that, I feel like it's kind of valid.
Yeah, it is valid. Like, it's just like less interesting, but what is interesting is that you say it so much, so it works.
That's right. That's right. I'm a nostalgia cynic.
Yeah.
I don't like it because I didn't grow up with
I
it.
I don't have to.
I don't like it because I don't have to.
You don't have to. I can't do fucking Doug's voice. Voice is too monotonal. Dead.
Hello, I'm a nostalgia cynic. I don't like it because I don't have to. And today we're going to be reviewing SpongeBob okay. Season 7.
Oh boy. Now we can actually start, even though I was already recording. Hello, my name is
wait, we're not... This is going to be like a 30-minute like introduction to the actual podcast.
Fuck yes.
Addendum.
Yes.
I'm the dog of the D's, but not really, and this is my show. And who are you people?
This show sucks, but that's why we love it.
That's right. We love it.
It sucks more than YMS at a horse show.
Yes, it sucks more than Ralph the Filmmaker on a daily basis.
We don't hate him because of his opinions, we just think his stuff sucks.
I hate him because he's gay.
I hate him because he has an opinion that I don't agree with and I'm childish about it. But that's besides the point. Welcome to the D-pad.
That's the correct opinion.
No, we are not a porn podcast. Please stop saying that we are. Voices in my head.
Exactly. I'm Easy Dog.
I can make that happen.
I'm drinking, Mark.
There's other people. Dunkin' Donuts.
Jeffrey Dunkin' Donut. Damn it!
Got it.
Don't fucking call me that. I'm Jeff.
Why do you have a video of Steven Spielberg hating Tokusatsu?
Because it's the worst video I've seen today.
Guys,
that video is shit.
He hates
but,
Tokusatsu.
But he's right.
Like, just because he's like that video isn't even about that. Like, that's just a clickbait title. Like, it's really about some butthurt nerd like mad that his fucking references are being like not included in the Ready Player One, the movie. Like, they're replacing Ultraman with the Iron Giant, and it's like
the Iron Giant is for feels, not action.
Like, Iron Giant is great.
Iron
hey,
Giant
don't
was
screw
amazing.
With me. I have the
one
power
of the guy,
God and Tokusatsu on my side.
and one of the guys' points about like the book being better is that the author drives a DeLorean. Is like, this guy has mad nerd cred. He drives a DeLorean. I think we're in good hands. This guy knows what he's talking about. He's a nerd like me. Yeah, he drives a car that's from a movie.
Someone said that Comic-Con, Steven Spielberg wants everybody in the theater to point at the screen and go, I remember that.
Yeah, I mean, possibly.
It was like, God, I mean, are we that much sheeple?
That movie just looks bad. In The Crows, I likened it to a joke from The Big Bang Theory. Let me see if I can find it again.
What if it has Big Bang Theory cast members in it? And it's like, I'm going to bazinga this.
Oh, fuck. I wouldn't be too surprised if they did something like
that. That'd be great. It reminds me of this like joke from The Big Bang Theory. Like the opening, like, 10 seconds have the joke and then
yeah,
like,
where they mention haha Transformers, Thundercats, yada yada.
Yeah.
Fuck you, how is this comedy?
Yeah. Like the movie
I'll
kind
tell
of
you how
seems
it's
like
comedy. It's where normal people can point at the screen and go, haha, they like things that kids like. Haha.
Like, and like the movie kind of just seems like that, the sort of like nonstop like referencing just for like effect of, oh man, I know what that is. Oh man, is that my favorite character from the obscure reference? Oh, man. Oh, dude, is that Darth Vader my favorite political icon?
This is a Warner movie, so he won't be in there.
Oh, man, is that fucking...
Is that Deadshot?
Is that Batman my favorite political icon?
Is that Light Turner my favorite anime hero?
Like, that's what it's going to be. And it's going to be shit. Hmm. The book seems shit. Nerd culture.
Fan fiction.
Yeah, nerd culture in general is shit. It's the worst, like, internet subculture. If you buy pop vinyls, you need to kill yourself.
I've only have, I think, two. One of them's Ryuk.
That's two too many. So,
I only have one, and that was because I needed it. I needed to buy it in order to fucking do a thing.
The other one is it was
a promotional thing where if you buy like $50 or more at Old Navy, then you get like $10 off. And then my mom was like, "Oh, just buy a thing."
What did they
just
get?
Buy
you?
It. Or fuck what, it. What I don't even care. I don't fucking give a shit about
you
Pop.
Still gave
Why do you
Funko
still have
your
it?
Money?
No,
you
I still want to hear your about money. Your Pop collection.
You still, you know, but the thing is, you still gave Funko money.
Exactly. Why
so
would you do that?
You're part of the problem. Burn it. Burn your Han Solo Funko Pop.
But
burn
it has a bobblehead, Jack.
Burn it. Burn it.
Snap
burn
its
a video.
Neck.
Burn
Snap
it and put
bobblehead.
On the burn it and make a video out of it, all right? Just remember to have proper ventilation.
This PVC will well.
Burning PVC will kill you. But you generally should burn it.
I mean, I just have two. One of Ryuk, one of Raven.
Yep, alright, burn those.
Why? Is it because they're incriminating evidence?
Yeah, you gave Funko money, so now you gotta, like, I don't know.
To be fair, I'm more of a Diamond Select guy because NECA is trash.
Oh, no, NECA's shit.
They have great designs, but plastic sucks.
Yeah, no, I got the one NECA figure I had broke on me within 5 minutes.
What was it?
It was one of the Pacific Rim ones.
Was it Gypsy Danger?
No, it was the Japanese one that didn't even show up in the movie. It just looked really cool.
Oh, Typhoon.
That's
Coyote
the Chinese.
Tango.
What?
Coyote Tango.
Something like that. It had like a jackal design. I don't know. Let's see if I can find it. Something Ronin, I think. Anyway, when Bandai Tamashii Nations announced that they had. That they got the right Pacific Rim 2, it was like a wave of relief.
Because I don't know, it's Universal. They tried to start a cinematic universe with The Mummy, so...
The Bandai Tamashii Nations got the toy rights to Pacific Rim. Anyway, here's the figure I had.
I saw that at Comic-Con. I saw the Comic-Con photos. The figures look absolutely friggin' amazing, but I'm...
Yeah.
Really more curious for Diamond Select because they have the rights too. So I wonder, are they going to be just re-releasing all the Pacific Rim stuff?
They could potentially be doing that.
Yeah.
What really got me excited is the Soul of Chogokin Gypsy Danger because it's a Soul of Chogokin figure. Soul of Chogokin, for those uninformed, is basically the best... super robot action figure line you can get.
I don't know, aren't they really small?
Soul Chogokins aren't. Super Robot Chogokin, the Step Down, are smaller, but they're also good because they still have diecast in them. But Soul Chogokin is like basically supposed to be the that's the Gypsy Danger. It's supposed to be like the best like figure version of like a lot of these characters that money can buy. Like I have the Evangelion Soul Chogokin and it's great.
Oh, you mean the less good Pacific Rim?
Oh,
what do you mean?
Shit.
Here we go.
I said it. Square up, Jabal. Let's go.
What? Gypsy Danger?
No, like Pacific Rim is better than Evangelion. Because
you're wrong.
Anime is trash.
Wait, are you the guy that said that? Are you the guy that fucking said had that like 6-point thing? That
what?
Is that someone else? Outlaw.
I think that's Logan. Jobby.
Yeah. Trench posted on Facebook this 6-point thing about why Evangelion or why Pacific Rim was better than Evangelion.
That was
and
him.
Him who made
yes.
that.
This is the man.
Oh my god!
Come on. Come on, square up!
No, what the fuck? Why the fuck you shitting on Jobby for, man?
I like Jobby, but he makes it so easy to shit on him.
I know, it's great. That's why I watch him.
It's like, you fat piece of shit. Just like... but I love him, though. I want Jobby to be my little brother so I can inappropriately carry him in public.
Yeah.
Like Yoda.
He's a pretty cool dude. I'm glad that he's successful now. I've been following him for a while. No, I've just been following him for a while.
We should try to get him on this.
He might be. He might.
Maybe he'll be like spurting something all over a swivel when we're talking to him.
Yeah, I don't know.
I could probably talk toys to him.
Like, maybe we could talk to Shinji impression.
Oh yeah, it's terrible. Because this is just like a thing that has carried over since me being a child. I just like constantly watch toy reviews online because I have nothing better to do.
Oh yeah, toy reviews are awesome. They're where you get some of the best ideas of whether or not you want a product. Because Before I got the Ninja Turtles and Power Rangers movie toy line, I had to go through some critics first because I wanted to make sure, is this a real investment I want to have on my collection shelf? Luckily, they were mostly good except for the Shredder toy, which I had to buy two Shredders so I could merge the heads.
Mm.
Thank goodness they were used.
Why are SH Monster Arts so expensive? I want the Shin Godzilla.
Shin Godzilla!
Sucks! But the story around it was pretty good.
Yeah, it was a bit of an allegory to Japan and nuclear weapons.
No, it was an allegory for them during that tsunami attack.
Tsunami attack?
Yes, it was actually Godzilla farting in the water.
A tactical tsunami?
It was a tactical tsunami. That sounds like something from one of those Metal Gear games. We need you to launch a tactical tsunami.
That sounds metal as fuck.
We're gonna coin that right here. Every time we get angry at someone, I want you all to type down a tactical tsunami. That's the D-pad. That's the D-pad podcast slogan. We're a tactical tsunami of nothingness.
At least we're not a Sharknado.
Fuck. You gotta reference
where they just make sequels because they can't make anything else. Like, seriously, you guys haven't made a superhero movie yet?
I know Seth MacFarlane's making Seth MacFarlane's making a new show. It's called The Orville.
Yeah, where it's basically Star Trek The Next Generation.
Oh yeah, I saw that and I just thought it was a Star Trek series because I haven't seen the trailer with the audio, but I was in the gym and they have TVs and that shows, oh, it's the new Star Wars series, new Star Trek series, and it's not, it's some completely different thing, and it was the most confusing thing I've seen.
Man, but then again, Star Trek sucks. Unless it's the Next Generation. Like, that's the one time I have to bow down to those nerds. It's like, Next Generation was really good because it has one of the best crying scenes ever, where Picard is in mud crying about how the Borg took him over.
Mm.
It was like, don't cry, Charles Xavier. Don't cry. We have yet to see you die in Logan, which is even more heartbreaking.
Really? And not the sentient poop emoji?
No. Well, then again, I don't know which is worse, him dying and being buried in a godforsaken forest in Logan, or him being the poop emoji yelling, we're number two.
His consciousness,
both are on par.
His consciousness went to the phone, that kid.
Oh, no.
And became the poop emoji.
I somehow remember owning a school. A gifted young mutant. And trying to have creepy eyes towards Mystique, even though she's clearly younger than me.
Oh my god, this piano scene is so well animated.
Yeah. Oh, you're watching the fucking... The Ava 3.0 piano scene.
Yeah, this is amazing.
I'm not gonna miss the animation about Evangelion. They get top-notch people to work on it, but here's the thing. Does Shinji ever sit back and go, what the hell is all this? Why haven't we communicated with these things? Why hasn't no one gone up there?
Because I'm pretty sure that
you can't.
Angel.
No, I think they attempted to, but the angels are after Adam. I'm pretty sure if the angels at least told them that what they were really after and what.
I don't think the angels are capable of conscious thought, aside from like Kaoru is like a weird exception, because I don't think Kaoru is full angel. I think he's like, I don't know. But
he's a statistical anomaly.
Yeah, I think the whole deal with Kaoru is that he's an angel who has the opposite of Rey, so that'd be He has Adam's soul.
Here's the thing. Why can't all the angels take on a human form? Why is it just Karu?
Honestly, I don't think Karu. I think Karu just has like Adam's soul in him.
Does that mean,
honestly,
like,
if Karu has
Ray, Ray has Lilith.
I thought Ray was Eve.
Ray is Lilith. Eve doesn't exist. Eve are the Evas technically, if you go by weird naming.
Oh great, we got a group orgy thing going.
Because something about the Bible and Lilith and shit. I don't know. I vaguely know what
this
is.
Yeah, we just pulled random shit from the Bible. We just stuck it to the air.
Well, I mean, because the Evas are Adam clones. They're called Eva, and you can mess with that and you get Eve, like in the Bible.
Bible.
And Lilith was like the one before Eve, and
you mean the book you see in a motel that you ignore?
Yeah. The free kindling that they give me. I don't know why, but you know it's a nice gesture.
The only people that kind of question anything are the people that have nothing to do with NERV. Like the kids at the school, you could tell they keep wondering, like, why the hell haven't we left Earth?
Honestly, like, yeah, that's the thing that I was wondering about the third movie. Like, they have a ship now. Why don't they just get the
fuck out?
Well, because the third movie is shit. You don't watch the rebuilds at all. The only reason why you watch the rebuilds is if you're trying to, like, show them to the girl you like at school who also watched Evangelion, and you're gonna fucking bang to the rebuilds, alright? That's what's gonna happen. That's the only reason why you watch the rebuilds.
Beats Dead Man Wonderland.
Yeah, that I'm sad it never got into like a second season.
No, I'm glad it didn't. I actually did a jig when I found out it was canceled.
I never watched it. It just seemed boring and bad.
It was. It's so stupid. It's basically like a dumber version of The Running Man.
Like, the concept seemed alright, but like death games are done to death. So
that wouldn't make sense in a prison thing unless it was a post-apocalyptic future.
Yeah.
Where if you did this, you earned your freedom.
Which is why we need Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, the anime, where it's just Thunderdome.
Or an anime of Gladiator.
Or just an anime of The Running Man.
Oh, that'd be good.
The Running Man is a great movie, and you could tell it was inspired by that Demon Wonderland stole that.
It's called
Battle
Royale.
They made it dumber.
It could potentially be Battle Royale as well. I don't know. I don't know how close they are.
Battle Royale was also influenced by it. That movie, although a schlocky piece of comedic 80s romp, has influenced a lot. And it's actually the better one of it because it was off-the-wall insane and a parody of American culture. By that time, game shows were huge, just like in the 70s.
Yeah.
People would get into conflicts over who can break the most boomboxes to win $200.
Yeah. I need to fucking finish
it's
the goddamn.
Almost like capitalism was never good.
I need to finish the book Battle Royale because like I got like halfway through and just never finished it.
Like a lot of things, Japanese.
Yeah. But the book was pretty. The book was really good from what I read, so I need to finish it to read it all.
Do you guys remember the topics I posted?
Oh yeah, just anime be adapted, I guess,
into the US or as films or
what? Oh, it's like a Ghost in the Shell, Death Note situation. Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, because believe it or not, sadly, those are the current better ones.
False on both fronts.
No, I mean, like, it's not horrendous beyond imagination.
Oh, yeah, no. Those are definitely the best examples of a live-action Western adaptation of anime. Because, like, the other one we got, the other two are... Speed Racer, I need to watch it again, but I've heard...
Speed Racer actually is pretty dang good, at least to me.
Like, I've heard it's good.
Fuck
like, Aaron,
you!
I know Aaron Hansen loves it. So, I just need to rewatch it. But Dragon Ball Evolution is just irredeemable.
Yeah. Dragon Ball Evolution should
Speed
never
be created. Speed Racer will never be redeemed because they never say, I need to go fast before you do. If you don't have that, you are not Speed Racer.
Like, he just has some verbal tick. He needs to speak
really fast. It's like, like, they do the dubbing thing. They have the camera things where they're always below angle shots.
I can't do the scene. But the scene where, like, I need to find it. 1 second.
Or the announcer going, now right behind Speed, it's Racer X, the mysterious rival. It's like, oh, come on, where is that? That's what people loved about it. It was kind of like a dumber version of Scooby-Doo. God help us when they adapt Voltron into a movie, which is going to happen whether we like it or not.
Probably.
Hell, we already have to put up with the Tumblr cringe remake on Netflix.
No, that's wrong. That's good.
It's all right. It's kind of hard to get into. Like, there's a couple of episodes.
Dirty Gaijins should never get their hands. That's the Speed Racer thing I was talking about. Dirty Gaijins should never get their hands on a superior Eastern culture.
Like Gold Lion.
Fucking goddamn Baka Gaijins need to get out.
Yeah, get out style. Get the fuck out!
But, like, adaptation, like, live action adaptations are not necessarily evil, just incredibly hard to pull off and haven't been pulled off well ever.
Yeah.
Voltron pulled it off very well.
Live action, dumbass!
Oh, live action!
I meant just, like, in general. Because that's an animated half-listed show. That works better. It was intended to be a live-action movie.
I mean, Voltron probably could work as a tokusatsu, but...
Yeah, people would turn it off in an instant. It's like, oh, great, it's another Power Rangers.
Like Steven Spielberg wouldn't even watch it, so...
Steven Spielberg hates tokusatsu.
Yeah, because we already know that Steven Spielberg hates tokusatsu, so...
He hates everything that doesn't have to do with his works or a book.
Yeah, he shouldn't really be talking because he sold to Disney, so...
He sold to everybody.
Disney's not necessarily evil, there's just Disney.
Especially Paramount. Because
no, Disney is very evil.
Directors he took under his wing.
Did you not know what I said? I said that Disney isn't terrible, but they're Disney, so they're evil. Disney sucks, and I hate them as a company. None of their movies are
even good. I just don't
like
them because they're creepy.
Like, none of them are even good. Disneyland is a shill. Don't go. I've never been.
It is.
I've never been, but I never want to be.
Don't go. Do not go. I've been there 3 times.
Too late for that.
All I did this weekend was just watch videos about like shut down Disney theme parks, and it was great. Discovery Island is the only good thing Disney ever did.
I agree.
Also, people who go on cruise ships for like vacations need to jump off the ships into the propellers.
From Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because
I don't like Steven Spielberg movies.
It's funny because Jurassic Park and Indiana Jones are two of my favorite movies.
I don't like them, but they're okay to watch on a plane or on a bus ride.
Jurassic Park is unironically a 10 out of 10 amazing film. So shut up.
I was actually going to say.
I agree 100%.
Have you guys actually heard that they're making another Jurassic Park game? But this one's actually a sequel to like the Jurassic Park game where you can create your own park.
Oh man, are they making a sequel to that?
Yeah, they are. It's called Jurassic Park World Evolution.
Finally.
I'm like, yes.
That's gonna be.
But when are they gonna make Lego? When are they gonna make Lego Jurassic World 2?
Oh, whenever the next one comes out.
Sorry.
It's like next year.
What we need is the Jurassic World extended universe.
Yeah.
I wouldn't mind that.
Honestly, like...
More dinosaurs?
One of my friends doesn't like Jurassic Park, and I don't know why. Like, his reasonings are like, the effects are bad, which is false. Have you not seen the movie recently? It looks great.
The old effects, I think, look better than... I'm going to get flack for this, but I think the old movie looks better than the new one.
Oh, no, yeah,
no, that is a very popular opinion.
Yeah, no.
Really?
Like, yeah.
Wow.
Say what you will, but an old film using practical effects has a longer impression than a film using CGI. Because
exactly.
They feel real.
Yep.
I like the Ninja Turtles movie, but the first movies were always good because they had realism to them, because they were physical things that were touching things. Like, oh, like, you know it's a guy in a suit, but when he picks up a piece of pizza from Domino's or drinks a Coca-Cola, he's actually doing it.
Yeah, that's a... yeah, that's a very common, like ideology people have about movies.
Or gore. Like, you see a dummy or a fake head's, like, head explode, like in the original 80s Maniac movie, it feels real because that's something actually being blown up with a real shotgun in the middle of the night in New York City in the 80s.
Yeah. But anyway, that's about how Blade Runner is the best film ever made?
It is.
And how the new one is going to kill it, and it's going to be shit.
I agree.
I don't think it's going to be shit. I think it's going to be good. But here's the problem. I think it's going to be like the original and bomb horribly because
opening up
next to another Minions movie, right? Like,
yeah, like
another one.
I don't know. Did you not have you seen the like? He's apparently releasing a bunch of short films leading up to they release the first one. I don't know where the other one.
I like the one where it involved Jared Leto, where he's blind and asks a replicant to stab himself.
That one. That's the one.
Even the people's like, he's a replicant, but dude, that's fucked up.
That's what I was talking about. I think that's the only one that's out right now.
My only problem is, wait, replicants aren't robots?
No, they're not. No.
Oh, they're just clone people.
Yeah, they're like weird clone people. Yeah, like Roy Black, like Batty was like bleeding in the movie.
Like, I wonder if he's going to give the same speech to Ryan Gosling.
What, Harrison Ford?
Yeah. He's like, I forgot the rest of the speech, so get off my plane.
Fucking, I really hope that they don't go the Deckard as a replicant route that like only Ridley Scott likes as a concept. Like, no one else thinks that they should do it, but like Ridley Scott really likes the idea of Deckard being a replicant, and it's dumb.
But then again, the movie kind of hinted at it because no one gave Deckard respect. They treated him like he wasn't even human. Like, especially that guy who speaks city speak. He's just like constantly insulting him. He's like, "Hey, you did a real man's work."
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck are you talking about? I just got my ass kicked and my fingers broken.
Yeah. But, like, and then, like, everyone's talking about the unicorn, but that was added in later for the final cut.
There's
like,
so many cuts of that movie.
Just watch Final Cut. I have them
final
all...
Final Cut Pro, you mean?
Yeah, the only good editing software.
No, you're wrong. Premiere is better.
What about Avid or Pinnacle?
Avid's good.
The actual Avid's professional decent. Tier, the actual professional tier ones, unlike Premiere, you fag.
No. They used Premiere to edit Shin Godzilla and Deadpool and other movies. So fuck.
Isn't it weird that some of the shots in Shin Godzilla were made on an iPhone?
Were they really now?
Yeah, certain shots the interior of buildings where Godzilla's walking by. That's done with an iPhone.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's called resources.
It's like filmmaking's evolving, which is kind of why how people who make movies with an iPhone nowadays are better than people in charge of making billion-dollar franchises.
Yeah, your camera phone is like actually like way more powerful than you think it is.
Than a Canon TF whatever.
Yeah, like it can't like if you know how to use like lighting and shit well, you can like make you can use your Canon camera phone really well.
But yeah, back to adaptations. I think adaptations are getting better. Like, say what you will about Ghost in the Shell and Death Note, but it didn't make you want to just burn the theater down after seeing it. You went going, okay, I see what they tried to do. This was a real fan of this trying to make something, but a studio was stepping in.
Yeah. About Ghost in the Shell, I wouldn't have known because the audience when I watched it was terrible. Fucking, alright, it was a bunch of kids, alright, with their goddamn fidget spinners, taking Snapchats during the entire movie with the flash on, talking over each other during the movie. They didn't watch the movie, they walked into the theater, alright, and fucking did whatever they were doing outside the theater, in the theater, during the movie that they paid money to watch, but they didn't fucking watch it. Why are they in the goddamn theater?
And you because didn't they knew toss you were there. Popcorn at them.
No, I didn't get
you
popcorn.
Should have tossed
they knew
popcorn
you were there,
at them.
So they brought their fidget spinners and Snapchats to just annoy you.
Like, and then like someone fucking called the staff on them, and they just gave like a stern warning, and they went back to it. They didn't kick them out. All right, I would have like fucking like kicked them out of the theater and banned them from like every establishment.
Just get the DVD of it.
But then it's not like the same. Like, I wanted to watch it in the theater because I like, I don't know, maybe I could like, because the movie visually, Ghost in the Shell, looks pretty good.
Yeah.
So, I mean, let's see that.
I'd make the case that it was decent. It was a decent
movie. Yeah, okay, it wasn't bad. All right, the movie was not bad. It was just
boring.
It was just boring and left no impression.
Then again, so was the original movie. It's hard
the original was very boring.
Yeah.
It felt the original was not boring at all.
The professor was going to hit his cane on your desk and ask you to write notes about it. I was like, wake up!
No, the original was not boring at all. Like, I really, really loved how slow-paced it was. It felt really good.
It's slow-mo-paced. It's like Blade Runner, the most boring, amazing film of all time.
Yeah, I don't know why people think Blade Runner is boring
either. I think
you're confusing
Blade Runner with 2001: A Space Odyssey.
Whoa! No, that's the greatest film ever made besides Christmas Day.
Yeah, but it's also boring.
Boring as shit.
Anyway,
it is pretty boring.
Oh all shit. Right.
I've
read like the first couple of chapters of the 2001 novel, and it's boring as fuck.
No, it's
I
like,
hate
the,
it.
It feels really good, like, in when they spend giant amounts of time, like, just out in space and there's no sound, it immerses you in the atmosphere and it's not all fast-paced where it gets all boring. Basically, it's just a subjective difference of taste there where I like things to be very, very slow, and 2001 does that poignantly and competently, and so I like it. But, like... And I'm specifically an outlier of that because, I praise the scenes where it goes really, really slow. Specifically the ones where it's just, like, a guy out in space. Like, I really like that. I kind of obsess over those parts. And most people, they complain about those, so... I don't know,
it's a guy in space talking to a computer, but I like to imagine that they're Rick and Morty.
Yeah.
Sorry, Dave. This conversation serves no purpose. Goodbye.
I need to watch 2001 again, probably, like in the dark, because I was watching. I just need to get a different like setting for it, probably. Mm-hmm. I'd probably like really like it if I like watched it again.
I
just didn't understand. Just didn't understand the what was happening with like, because I was like, I don't know. I just need to get that explained.
I first watched the movie when I was 8, I thought I understood it pretty well. Like, there's some.
I don't know. I guess I wasn't paying that much attention.
Yeah. I mean, there's some like political subtext in the movie, but I don't think that actually matters. It's only, like, postmodernists and hipsters who care about that stuff. Like, the main meat, like, of what the actual movie is, I think it's pretty easy to understand, but I don't know.
Yeah, I guess I just need to watch it again.
When I saw that movie when I was 8 years old, that I was, like, blown away. It was, like, mind-expanding at the time. I loved it so much. And not for any pretentious reason, it's just I really... was just enthralled by it with just a childlike sense of wonder when I saw it. Like, basically, my experience with 2001 is what a lot of people had with Star Wars.
Well, you see, I didn't grow up with 2001, so, like, I probably don't appreciate it like you do, so...
Yeah.
Same here.
I mean, I thought about watching it, but I can't get past the monkey scene because I got so bored during that part.
I don't know. The monkey scene's great. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I thought that was amazing. Again, that was like another one of those scenes where it was like, whoa, it's like evolution, and they're doing a thing, and it's whoa,
God,
dude.
Evolution
this
is so boring. It took so long to get things done. Freaking lazy monkeys.
Yeah, I need to watch.
Evolve faster.
So I probably need to watch it again. I really like the monkey. The monkey scene's great. I just need to watch the rest of the movie again, probably.
I need to get back.
Time.
I actually think for now that Death Note is one of the better anime adaptations because, one, that anime can get super long, and I've never seen the anime, but I've seen bits and clips of it, and it looks like it really has this slow burn thing. And this felt like, when I saw the movie, it felt like an homage to those old 80s films, where it felt like it was this collection of things put into one thing to where it was very cohesive for me. But I do have to admit, the guy that got to play Light was not the best thing. I mean, clearly the girlfriend was probably supposed to play Light, but at the last minute is like, change it to a dude and make her the girlfriend. Because
how do you guys feel about the gender swapped fucking Lord of the Flies that they're doing?
I don't know.
Is it still gonna end where all the kids cry when they see adults there?
I just find that ending
so funny for some reason.
Lord of the Flies is a great book.
Yeah.
It really is.
Because it shows the bitter reality of humanity.
But they're probably gonna like dull it up a bit, you know, because
are they gonna make it? What would happen if Michael Bay got to direct it?
I would be all over that right away.
Yeah, man. Yep. Like, you do, man. Michael Bay.
Are we still talking about 2001: A Space Odyssey?
No, we're talking about We're talking about
why Death Note the movie is better than 2001.
No, it's better than Ghost in the Shell.
We're talking about how the gender swapped Lord of the Flies is going to be the best film to hit modern cinema of all time.
Misogyny.
Can we just all say that the actor who plays Light in Death Note is really cute?
No,
he is. He's also part of the Naked Brothers band.
Oh,
yeah,
was he?
Yes, he was the older brother character and had one of the best scenes in cinema history.
I'm not a gay boy, so I don't know.
But seriously, he's obviously a nice kid, and I just felt like it was a joke that they told him to act like that. And like, he's like, is the scene good? He's like, totally. Why is everyone snickering every time I'm on screen? No reason.
They should have got the guy from Fault in Our Stars and Baby Driver.
Probably wanted to get Ansel Elgort, man.
The best. I don't know. Baby Driver was good. I haven't seen him in anything else, but
I need to see that.
Yeah, Taxi Driver was really good.
I need to see Taxi Driver. I keep seeing good things.
Oh man,
I really need to watch.
Are we talking about my favorite game for the Sega Dreamcast, Crazy Taxi?
No, Crazy Rebel Taxi is better.
I really need to watch Speed, the movie about the bus that explodes if it doesn't go slow, or it goes too slow. So
that movie. Oh, that's what the movie was.
What?
Oh, I forgot to mention the day Speed. Trailer dropped. Speed. Next Netflix's The Magic School Bus.
Oh yeah, no, it looks terrible.
Yeah.
Before I turned it on, I said, "Please let this be a normal trailer." But the frizz,
with the
no
frizz,
way.
No way.
That's right. Shitty.
I mean,
I mean,
the trailer itself seemed normal, but the show looks like a garbage fire.
Like a Skechers.
Is it animated or live action?
It's animated, but it looks like. Honestly, I'm fine with it being like a 2D Flash. I just hate the character designs. They look like fucking Bitmoji. And that's just
Have
terrible.
Have you seen The Magic School Bus?
The Magic School Bus looks fine.
He's talking about the remake.
All right, it looks better than what they're doing now.
Focus. Wake up.
Because most of what happened in The Magic School Bus would probably make you think, were these kids on acid or something?
No, they were just on a magic school bus.
I've always had an idea for a Magic School Bus parody where they're about to drive off and then a bus hits them. ironically, another bus hits them, sending, like, it causes, like, the magic school bus to explode, and then it's just a montage while the music plays and the kids' bodies being hauled out of the bus. Fucking it turns out they were all, like, covered in heroin needles.
Fucking Green Bird from Cowboy Bebop starts playing as they fall out of the fucking... No, from episode 5 where he falls out of the window.
Oh, no, I was thinking more just the Magic School Bus theme where it's just, it's playing, and, like, there's a jukebox, like, somehow out of there, or, like, a record player that's playing the Magic School Bus theme.
So it's the juxtaposition of the terrible with the happy. Okay, all right.
Yes, I love that stuff because, like, what's more better? It makes people feel really uncomfortable.
Very, like, very postmodern of you.
I don't speak hipster, so.
I just wanted
to make something fucked up and funny.
Yeah. Oh, the anarcho-capitalist doesn't speak hipster, okay.
So,
says the anarcho-capitalist.
I'm afraid that this is our new YouTube fad.
Yeah, where we call each other fascists and capitalists.
Oh, no.
Coca-Cola? Yeah, this might be our new...
Wait a minute. Outlaw Harvest is trending on YouTube?
What? It says, get fucked, fatty. Not too harsh.
Like, not harsh enough.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we don't want Kitty to manually demonetize us.
That's right, she did it.
You let her run your life.
As if we weren't demonetized already.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this video is shit.
No.
Oh man, he's doing it. He's gonna axe a keyboard, guys. He's gonna take an axe to a keyboard.
The D-pad will be the next hour.
Why are you watching it?
I'm just trying to
fucking
see.
Why are you watching Adult Swim?
Yeah, okay, this seems like shit.
Speaking of Adult Swim, what would you guys say if they were to ever bring Megas XLR onto Adult Swim?
I wouldn't care, because I haven't seen the original.
I am currently watching the original. I got it to episode 4 a few hours ago.
And my opinion on old children's cartoons has already been set in stone as I don't like them. Not a big fan.
No. You would probably just imitate Trevor Belmont. I don't care.
Like,
that's literally what he says.
Yeah.
Like, in the first few episodes.
Just Castlevania?
Yeah, the Castlevania. The new Castlevania.
More like Slut Sylvania.
More like.
Super Mario Brothers movie was a better adaptation, Vanya.
Whoa. This is a politically correct show here.
Yeah, use your nouns, you cis male.
Yeah,
guys, we talk about
this is a very liberal podcast. Okay, there are Mario no right wing beliefs here.
Can we talk about the real hard news going on? Mario is no longer a plumber.
He's no longer a plumber. He is a sewer serviceman. Thank you, service person. Sorry.
So Nintendo is like, Mario's like, he, like, they, like, for, like, Mario Odyssey, they were like, Mario, like, had, like, a whole, like, bio on Mario, and he's, like, used to be a plumber. So Mario is no longer a plumber.
Well, he's made so much money from all of his adventures. You'd think he would still be plumbing.
I don't know.
He's paid in spaghetti.
He's diabetic,
so he doesn't eat it.
He just does it for the love of the job, man, you know?
He's a scat fetish.
I just thought he's the guy who's in the permanent friend zone because he realizes a princess doesn't want to bone a fat, short, mustachioed, stereotypical Italian man.
Whoa. This is a politically correct show.
AKA
we do not
Movie Bob.
Oh. That was top.
Movie Bob, my hero.
Movie Bobbio.
Your hero is a zero.
Oh yeah!
Oh, dude, you fucking got him there, dude. He's like, dude, man, he's gonna have to fucking take like a lot of fucking time to like recover from that sick burn, fag.
Okay, I could just gave up halfway through. Just use the horrible expletive because you're just bombing. Just might as well just go with style, you know. Go with gusto.
Go out with style.
Go big or go home.
Yeah. Like, yeah.
Yeah, like Shinji in that one doujin.
where him and Kaoru fuck and Third Impact happens because of that. And
that's real.
That's real. Fuck this anime.
Just for the sake of the joke, YMS is there, but he was a horse with his long hair. Going, wow, I sure didn't like this.
You tell me this is Ava Doja, where Shinji and Kaoru fuck, causing Third Impact.
Yeah,
this is my own. I was just joking.
It's too much time in your hands.
Too much time. We're all nerds. We have way too much time in our hands, and we'll be that way even when we have careers and families.
Yep.
That's honestly great.
It shows the bitter reality of man. No matter what, we will always have too much time on our hands, even though we complain that we don't have enough. No, you always do have time on your hands.
Outlaw. Does the fucking happen because of the, like, does Third Impact happen because they fuck, or is it because they're too busy fucking and that Third Impact happens?
I don't know. I can't read Chinese.
Oh.
That's not translated. Was it a joke?
I hate it when, like, doujins are translated into other languages that aren't English, because it's like,
I fucking know, right? It's bullshit. Why does China get doujins before we do? That's fucking gay.
Why does China? I thought China banned porn.
They did, and that's what doesn't make any fucking sense. Why does China get the fucking good doujins when we don't?
Because they own us.
Why can't I fucking, like, jerk off to fucking the fucking Gerudo Link from Breath of the Wild getting pegged by that one Gerudo chick while that in my fucking native tongue? Come on, man.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Exactly. I had something, but I lost it.
Yes.
Ooh. Wasn't that good anyway, so whatever.
But yeah, second topic is about fan games. Do you think fan games should be allowed?
Yes.
We need to ban them, like we must ban the free market.
I mean, it's fine, but, like, I don't necessarily care for, like, Pokemon Uranium, like, because it just doesn't look good to me. Fans in general need to stop anyway.
We need to eugenics fans.
Yeah.
That's definitely how it works.
I'm going to hijack this podcast now. We're going to talk about how eugenics is justified and how what Iceland is doing with Down syndrome is what we should be doing with all disorders.
Yes.
What? Yes.
So we just kill everyone on this podcast. Fair enough.
Yeah.
We're all too autistic to live.
Yeah. Because, like, in Iceland, just, parents who test their fetuses, and if they get, like, positive tests for Down syndrome, they're, like, most of the time they'll abort the fucking fetus, and it's, like, the smart thing to do, because you're either knowledgeably burdening your child with this incurable lifelong disease, or you're just you're ending it before, like, it even has a chance to live, which is better than having Down syndrome.
That's kind of messed up.
Fuck you. Abortion should be legal. It's not your
choice.
My body,
my choice, Mark.
Exactly.
I agree.
Honestly, I don't see how this is an issue. Like, if you don't believe in it, then you don't have to do it. But, like, let other people do it if they feel that they should be able to do it.
Fair point.
Yeah, it's the exact same logic I have with why I believe, like, all drugs should be legal.
Yeah, no, I believe that too. Like, safely get it to them, like, but, and if you don't, like, want to do it, then you don't have to do it. Right?
Yeah.
It's also why, like, abstinence-only sex education is bad, because people are going to fuck. You might as well educate them on what's going to happen when you stick your dick in that vagina, all right? You're going to get AIDS or the girl pregnant.
Or yeah, but I also believe that school should not be required after a certain point, and that it should be more democratic. Like, you should be able to choose what you get.
And you should be able to choose.
I feel like
that's how
be...
it is in Canada. We're allowed like to choose what we take.
I feel like that should, there should be some sort of like standards that you have to take, but largely free, like.
Yeah.
Like
yeah, exactly.
Gradually, that's... you should have to take like a math, science, English, social studies class. Like maybe like.
See the best. Like, okay. Okay. Let me
have,
explain
like,
to
the
you.
Libertarianism.
Let me explain to you why the school system in Canada is way better than the one in the U.S. right now.
Because we because you guys are actually, you know, giving them attention, whereas we're just basically giving us subjects and just be like not really discussing
somewhat,
most of it.
Somewhat, it's still kind of stupid and gay, but for eighth grade, you have to take all of your mandatory classes, English, language studies or whatever, social science, math, and then whatever else, I think elective courses or whatever, PE, that kind of thing. But then once you get to grade 10, half of those drop. Like, you drop most of those courses after grade 10. In grade 11, it's like math, language, science, and English, math, science, and what else? There's one more, I feel like. Anyways. And then by grade 12, English, math, science, and French or language study. And then once you get to grade 12, all you have to do is take English and your language. And then everything else is a choice. Like, this year, because I fucked up chemistry big time last year. So I'm taking English, French, and biology. And then the rest of it is, like, elective classes.
Boring.
Get fucked. I'm telling you why it's better. It's a better system.
Are you shit-talking the superior science biology? Like, chemistry is shit. All right? I'm gonna...
Chemistry's fucking boring.
I'm gonna steal your... I'm failing chemistry right now because they
fucked up chemistry big time. Jeff, I got a 19% in chemistry second term last year.
Oh my god, how are you gonna go to college with that such a shitty GPA? Why can't I go to the socialist Canada? Larva, can your family adopt me for the rest of my high school career?
Yeah.
The half the fucking semester that it is.
Totally.
All right.
I actually read somewhere that
I'll fucking exchange student into your school.
Yeah, do it. Do it.
What were you going to say, Mark?
I read somewhere that someone actually was going to, when they finished their school, like their school term and stuff, they were like, I kind of wish that they taught me these three skills. Woodsmanship or woodcrafting, home economics, and, well, economics. Because quite literally, those are the only three skills that you need when you're done with high school. When you're done with high school.
Those are like things that you can take. I took home ec first year in grade 8, because it was like a mandatory thing. It's like you take three electives and you rotate through it. And it's home ec, economics, and woodworks.
The three
mandatory classes. I think other people got like foods first term, but whatever. Anyways, but those are like it's three electives that you rotate through each semester or each term, and it's the best thing because you get to sample everything. And if you don't know that something's not for you, and you don't take it next year.
Mm. Yep.
No, just something I know is because if it were. Because if I'd known that, I would have taken those classes. Then maybe I could be at least, you know, proficient with, like, those classes.
Yeah, the thing about school is that it doesn't actually prepare you for real life or for critical thinking. It just prepares you to go in the job market. And even then, it doesn't do that. Like, the entire point of school is not actually to educate you. It's to put you into a job, you know, and then to be in a job forever, basically. So basically it's a spook. Like, they don't actually teach you things. But if it was done, you know, more democratically, and if there was more actual stuff to do, and there was reforms to how it was taught, like, even then, like I say, it's for getting a job. That's the point of school. But even then, it does that terribly, you know? And it doesn't, talk about how careers are specialized. It more so goes into, like, STEM, because that's what's good for the economy.
You mean the worst field?
Yeah, most people will not go into STEM. Most people will not, just statistically speaking.
People who say that there needs to be more STEM jobs need to take the stem of my dick into their mouth. Sorry, shut up.
Can we just talk about fan games, please?
That's what we're talking about, fan games.
No, we're talking about economics.
Yeah, my favorite fan game, the game of life.
And how schools should, and how, like, fucking, their high school probably didn't have a game design class to making them, help them make them fan games. They had to do it themselves. They had to relearn a whole skill, all right? So if school can't teach me how to make my own Pokemon ROM pack.
No. In Canada, there are schools, there are either specific schools or courses in college that teach game design.
Okay, college doesn't count. High school is what we're talking about.
Fuck you!
Is college free in Canada?
That's the worst episode ever.
No, but there is a really cheap college, like, down the road from where I live.
Yeah, in Germany, there's free college, so that makes it better.
I mean, technically,
yeah, $30, and they have really cool. All the courses that I want to take, so I'm, like, looking at them mainly.
I mean, yeah, that's technically, in Tennessee, you can get, like, the first 2 years at college free.
You can. I've looked at that.
Yeah. And I mean, it seems like an all right deal.
Mm. Yeah, it is.
Like, just to get those first two out of the way, and then go on to whatever.
Yep.
But that's only if you want to go to school in state, which I don't.
I don't really want
to do, because I don't want to be stuck in Tennessee forever.
Yeah, neither do I. I'm going straight to live in Germany, and I'm going in the military.
Man, you'll not be the enemy in the Third World War. Be the first World War when Germany is an ally.
Yep.
It's such an exciting prospect.
I'm gonna be able to get my citizenship quicker, because if you're in a domestic partnership for 2 years or whatever, to a German citizen especially, like, or if you're married alternatively, like, it will make it to where your citizenship process can get expedited, but I will lose my American citizenship in the process, which I am losing absolutely no sleep over.
Just take the test and get it back, you know? It's not that hard.
Yeah, but I don't think I don't want to ever come back.
Don't blame you. Can't come back. It's not like they're gonna ban you from America for moving to Germany and abandoning your country.
I think he can do it.
Please point out how uncomfortable I feel hearing all of this. What's wrong, Trench?
Yeah, it's cringy, it's a good kind of cringy.
Oh, there's shit going on in the fucking chat for a while. I wasn't even paying attention. I was too busy looking at Gunpla.
Top 10 anime betrayals, and then it has Digi, like, behind Giguk stabbing him with a mic.
What was I gonna say? We're talking about... Oh, yeah! So, talking about bullshit in America, right?
The worst.
Why do only men have to fucking sign up for the draft legally? Legally required, men have to do it when you turn 18.
When you're in Canada, you don't have to go into the military. Yeah, come to Canada. We are fucking great.
Like, it's just a draft. You don't get put into the military. It's just the draft, which is still fucking terrifying.
I like the military. The military is cool.
Military would be cool if I had cool robots, but they don't.
You can go to, like, the reserve, fucking the reserve places and just fucking be in the military and not go into active service and just be in a fucking military base the whole time.
But what cool. really gets me is that it's just men. Like, why? Like, fucking
respect women.
Where the fuck are the third wave feminists complaining about that?
Uh-oh.
Fucking gay, and I hate
respect
this.
Respect women, basically.
No. Yeah, well, respect. If women, but it's not. It doesn't respect women because it implies that they're not capable of fighting.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's why we need to respect women. You know, yeah. I agree with you.
But not, you know, be just like, how do I say it without sounding like an ass?
Women actually have it better than men because they can just fuck whoever they want.
Oh boy, we got Monkey here. The most red-pilled man.
People, am I right? okay.
Okay, what's our third topic?
Technically, I count as a minority.
Got it.
Basically, at the end of this second topic, we're okay with fan games, and we're okay with politics.
Yeah, let's go with that.
Yeah.
Welcome to Basic Economics with Outlaw Harvest.
We banned politics from the Chromasticators. I don't know why we're talking about it now.
This
Chromasticators,
is the Chromasticators.
Like the Chromasticators.
Yeah, I need to step up my leadership.
Funny joke. That hasn't been made before at all.
Nope, has not been made at all in the Crow Channel at all.
Really? Multiple people have made that joke at you guys? That's kind of sad. Someone would actually do that, and it wasn't me.
It's just happened before, right? I don't know. Probably. Actually, I don't think.
Oh, okay. I got a really dumb, spicy, delicious, hot and ready topic for you.
Anime babies. Model kits.
No. It's something.
No, I'm on Amazon. I'm just looking at Gunpla.
I'd rather just look at goth girls.
Can I put that?
Oh, why not both?
Where the fuck?
We need to do a Pan Pizza Cast Part 2.
No.
Shut your
whore
mouth.
I guess not. The man
okay,
spoke.
Okay, here it is. This is
The man spake. He don't want.
No.
Can I
no,
get
I
a
didn't.
Gunpla
Shut up.
Of
no.
my favorite guy, Kim Jong-un?
Probably.
I don't know, I guess.
Wait, you can get a Gunpla of that? Really?
No.
You can I get a pop figure of Kim Jong-un?
I'm Googling this. Someone probably has
made
James like a.
James Franco.
Oh, damn, I can't find it.
Oh Lord.
I'll just sum it up. It was kind of dipping back into politics and also the furry community, and it was basically saying that
my favorite community.
That's right. You know you like it. It was basically saying that the reason that people hated furries back in like the early 2000s and 90s was. I don't know, some sort of anti-LGBT or something. I don't know. It seemed really...
I thought it was anti that scene from The Shining.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was anti-humanity because furries are not human.
Yeah.
No, they're non-humans.
They're subhuman, meaning... And it's fine, all right? This is
you
why
could,
we need this...
You could say they're...
Just hold on. Slow down, honey. It's okay. You got it. You can do it.
Worst thing to hear in a porno.
It's alright, son. It's okay.
Slow,
but,
slow down, honey. You got it.
We're all going to hell.
But,
no, hell is this, being alive.
This is why, and this is why we need
C.
to have...
Trench knows what's up.
This is why we need to have an internet. We need
stay
to, like...
Stay woke.
Government. Yep. This is why we need government spending to fund international furry conventions as like it's like internment.
And you know who the mastermind
camps.
Is? It's YMS.
We'll have we'll have them. We'll use them as like internment camps for furries. Like
yeah, we can justify it on taxes as a cure for autism.
Yeah.
Hey, as someone
you know, autism
AU, I take offense to that.
Autism speaks. We'll love it.
Autistic,
yeah, autism speaks.
Oh, Austin
we'll
the
love
autist.
It. You know, they'll pay even more taxes just to have this because you know it's benefiting the community. It's making them feel safe.
Autism Speaks, the best fucking charity.
They usually get a guy with autism.
I should talk totally normal,
like nothing's
wrong. You know
what
I should do?
Fun fact, Autism Speaks is actually a terrible organization, apparently.
It is.
Like,
no, it's yeah. terrible. Like,
their whole mantra is that like it's like inhuman and should be destroyed, essentially.
Yeah, it's legitimately disgusting. I hate Autism Speaks a lot. But I'm not gonna get in a tangent about that. But like I don't know, maybe Mr. Inter did a good video about that.
Well, no, we're already here. Just go on the rant, do it.
Yeah, I don't care. I'm
I would just be reiterating all of Mr. Inter's points.
Mr. Inter, where he stops in between sentences.
Do you really think we're going to watch a mysterious Mr. Enter video to fucking learn about your opinion of Autism Speaks? I just want to hear it now.
I don't.
Mr.
Like
Enter
will
be on here being like, "Hey, I don't like what you're saying about that."
Oh no, right link. There. I guess link the video. I'll probably just put it up on the corner.
And you'd be like, "Well, I'm exercising free speech. It's free speech whether you like it or not."
Oh yeah, Mr. Inter is. I love Mr. Inter.
He's a good boy.
Yeah, he is.
I don't see why people care so much about fucking Cartoon Network shows.
Because we're bored.
Whoa! Did you just bad talk Lego Unikitty?
Have you guys seen that photo of like some sort of brush fire headed right towards Cartoon Network Studio?
Oh man, really?
I wanted to post a picture of that guy from Taxi Driver going, "Great cleansing's happening. One big flood's gonna come through here and just clean it all." Like, yeah, start at the source of the cringe.
Yeah.
Everyone's like, okay, this is getting kind of creepy.
The best episode of the D-pad confirmed.
Where you see Austin Trich reveal his anarchistic views?
Yeah, anarchy
is Cartoon
not...
Network.
Is not a good ideology. Libertarianism is, but anarchy isn't.
Libertarianism means we just want you to leave us the fuck alone while we collect mass amounts of gold and guns within our homes. Yes, I am doing a bad Ron Swanson impression.
But like anarchy, specifically like anarcho-capitalism, like what your ideology is, Trench. Like,
we just
want to
make money.
Children, like, yeah, but you can make money under the current system. Like, there are children who would be put into labor, you know, there would be people would be selling other people slaves.
They already do that. Have you not seen that viral golf game video where someone actually auctioned off a player? Wait, no, it was a football game where someone auctioned off a player.
It's called fantasy football. It's different.
It still doesn't help the situation.
I don't understand.
It looked like slavery thing.
It did. Yeah, that's the whole point.
It's like 2900. Just saw a picture of his head. It felt like that scene from Get Out.
Fucking
a bunch of wanting to be a black person.
That's what I thought when I saw.
Spoilers.
Get Out. Is Get Out a good or bad movie? Here's the poll.
I have not seen it.
Get Out. I liked it. I liked it.
I heard it was stupid. Also, we watched it in one of my writing classes. I didn't watch it because I didn't care to watch it.
I watched it in the film class I took over the summer and thought it was actually kind of good. It wasn't scary, but it's not meant to be like a horror film. It was meant to be just like more of a, I don't know. I just thought it'd be a well-made film telling a decent story. A lot of people think that movie's
racist when the whole thing was people wanting to be black, so they just put their brains in another person's body.
Yeah.
It's kind of like benevolent racism, I guess. Like fetishization.
They're not doing it because they're racist.
Because they just want to be cool.
Yeah, no. Well, I mean, their reason. I forget what their reasoning in the.
Well, the reason was because the main guy didn't want to lose his parents because they were getting old and dying, so he had like this ridiculous idea to like. What if I put their brains in a younger
That was honestly for me the scariest part, where like they were cutting open the guy's brain, and it was just like had like the saw going around the head, and like just, I was not into that.
It's kind of like in that show Hannibal, where Will Graham's head was about to be sawed off until something stopped it.
Like just
like you just saw him like jerk around as soon as the saw hit the top of his skull. He's like, oh fuck.
Yeah, no, like that's the one thing that gets me. The one thing that gets down to my core and scares me shitless
is fucking that.
You know what gets me?
What?
You really want to know? I want everyone on the internet to hear this.
What
scares me to this day isn't violence, isn't the current state of political policies,
awesome,
or the threat of nuclear war. It's snot fetish videos that scare the shit out of me. Because I found out those existed by accident on Vine.
Mamma mia.
What snot? The Lego building technique? Studs
no,
not
like,
on top?
Snot fetish videos. Oh,
man.
Women, like,
yeah.
Spurt snot from
Did
their nose.
Did someone just say Lego?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Let's never discuss this ever again.
Yeah, I think I'm done.
And I saw a man almost die in a car accident. It's like, that's nothing compared to this.
You know, studs not on top. The Lego, the technique in which Legos are built with studs not on top.
You know, guys, I'm skeptical about Lego Unikitty.
Are you
armored
skeptical?
Are you an armored skeptic?
Yes, I'm an armored skeptic about Lego Unikitty. I'm gonna change the video title
to
that.
A feminist screwed me over when I should have saw it coming.
I'm gonna change the video title to that.
I look like Elder Maxon with the dad body.
Armored skeptic.
I called out Barrett even though I had no room to actually call him out.
Armored skeptic, more like I bank off my girlfriend's success. Chick.
Who's
younger than me?
Okay, now I think you should end it off. No. Quiet.
Are we ending
it, kids? Yes, we're ending it.
Is the podcast over?
Yeah,
is there an outro?
I guess.
The outro is, it just ends.
Yeah.
All right.
We need to make an outro for this.
Thank you for watching this cringe. Be sure to check us out some other time.
Does anyone actually watch this? Let's be honest here.
No, but it's nice to think that people do.
No. If you act like it, then people will come. What's the fuck? If you build it, they will come, you know?
If you look at
well,
the last
hey,
episode,
this isn't that kind of podcast. We don't know. We want to hear your kinks.
No, it's like fucking live from a shitty, from a goddamn baseball movie. You
or really crappy ad Kevin Costner porn
yeah.
movie.
Yeah, I don't like.
Where
just,
Kevin Costner sounds like this.
Field of Dreams
for
or something
a whole
like that.
2 hours.
I don't care. Baseball, sports
I don't care
movies.
About dry land.
Don't end the podcast. You need to go on a rant about sports movies and how they're the worst genre.
No.
Okay, well, sports anime is great.
Sports anime is different from sports movies, all right? Because sports anime is like high, like action and shit.
It's so ridiculous.
Sports movies are the same story done a billion times. They're all boring because they're real world sports, and sports are shit.
Okay, I agree with that. I agree with that.
Like every football movie is the same movie because football is just a bad sport in general, and that's my point. You can end the podcast now.
Yeah, we're done.
All right. Thanks for having me on, guys. I'm tired, and I gotta edit some videos. Thank you all so much. See you guys next time. Hopefully Turkey Tom can be on, because he's just as negative as Outlaw Harvest, only worse.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, please.
I will link you guys Turkey Tom's channel, and I want you to just say, Trench sent us here, and holy crap, this is bad.
Yeah,
bananas.
Please link me. I want to know who this is now.
By the way, it's creepy because he's younger than me. It's like,
oh,
hey,
how old is he?
PM. I think he's like 14.
You have to babysit more children. Fuck.
Someone needs. Out. I took him under my wing against his will in my van.
Okay. Well, okay. Goodbye.
Kicking and screaming, but eventually he chilled out.
You gotta lock him in a cage so his muscles weaken.
No, I only have one thing in a cage, that's and that's movie. Raven. Where she just looks at me, flips me off, and just lies on her back, and then I just take little photos of her.
Okay.
The pizza voice is almost uncanny. Pretty soon it'll be good enough to actually be him.
Yeah, when are we gonna do Pan Pizza Cast Part 2, but with Neros Q?
Oh, Neros.
Yeah, I added him to the chat. Yeah, see ya, Jeff.
Yeah, boy, Death Note is amazingly bad.
I'm gonna drop this in the chat, and then I'm gonna bounce.
What is it?
It's a fucking Lego mock, and it's the coolest shit. I love this guy. He does cool things.
Cool.
Subscribe to him. He does good stuff.
Subscribe to what?
Anyway,
to what?
Yes.
Okay, bye-bye.
Watch Make 604.
Yeah, do you want to just, like, talk in the chat a little bit? Because I have some things I want to tell Mark.
Oh, yeah, okay, I'll...